then. It will be telephone, it will be good television viewing, sorry, good television viewing for us to remember when we were all locked down and had to do this by Zoom. So, once again, good evening, everyone. My name is Ishale Robinson Cooper. I have known the birthday girl for over 20 years now, and it falls to me to be the master of ceremonies for this evening. Before we go into the formal bit of it, I just want to say that, Wendy, I love you. I wish you all the best. I wish you many more years on this earth of joy.
Thank you so much. I receive.
Okay, so at this time, as we move through, I would like to introduce Apostle Diane Williams, just to say a little bit about her. Apostle Diane Wilson is a powerful woman of God. To the celebrant, she is a divine connector and destiny helper. Let's welcome Apostle Diane Wilson to open in prayer and bring greeting. Over to you, Apostle.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening to you, Wendy, and a blessed, prosperous, fantabulous birthday to you.
It is Thank you so much.
Your friends and your family and your loved ones and all those who consider you the precious gem that you are. And so as we start this evening's proceeding, can we just, wherever we are, connect in our spirit to send positive thoughts, good wishes beyond our words, and just be in a posture where we can invite the presence of God so that he can do what he promised to do, and that is to be with us forever. Father, this evening we come in your presence. We come because your word bids us to come, and we love to be in your presence with your people, giving you the praise, the thanks, the glory, the honor that is due to your name. Tonight, we particularly thank you for your daughter, Wendy, the one that you have chosen to put on the earth at such a time as this, because she has something awesome to do on your behalf. We pray your divine blessings. We pray, God, that the windows of heaven will continually be open over her life, so that even as she steps into this new frontier, her eyes will not see nor her ears hear, nor her heart can conceive the things that you have in store for her, because she loves you and she has submitted to your lordship. But by your spirit, we ask that you will download to her the great and marvelous gifts that you continue to have released to her, so that she would never forget the reason or the purpose. Help her to celebrate God with an understanding that she's already loved, she's already chosen, she knows who she is, and that is enough. God, tonight, all that will be said and done, we commit into your hands. And we know that you will bless, that you would help, and you will guide from the chairperson, go right back. So that at the end of it all, your name will be glorified and we will all feel uplifted as if we had a birthday ourselves because we were in your presence. Thank you for today. Thank you for Wendy. Thank you for everyone that is on. Thank you for being a good God. And we thank you for all of this in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. And amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Thank you very much, Apostle Diane Wilson. It was a beautiful prayer. Thank you very much to open the proceedings. So now it falls to me to introduce my very good friend, Wendy Lewis, to me known as Wendis. So we'll start with making a note that her character is very bold, of which we're all aware. Her personality is strong. The atmosphere shifts when she enters a room unapologetically, and so it should. She was born in the UK and currently resides in Trinidad and Tobago in the Caribbean. As an author, radio and TV host, motivational speaker, mentor, corporate trainer, marketing communication strategist, and ordained minister, and friend to many, I would add, this vocal powerhouse and charismatic speaker was born to talk. There's no doubt about that. Wendy is on a mission to create change and impact lives globally. Her messages are real. Her purpose is clear, and her mission is to ensure equality for all, corporately, emotionally, and financially. Wendy's bio is colorful, stemming from the banking industry in the UK, 30 years in entertainment, politics, and much more. One of her quotes reads, "There is no lack of wealth. There is a lack of wisdom. There's no educational advantage, but a misconception of what education really is. A spiritual journey is wrapped in divinity, purpose, trials, then testimonies, valleys, and victory. From Wendy, London's Calypso monarch and soca queen, to ordained minister, it's time to serenade the queen of the evening. Where is the queen of the night?"
Hello, 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 everybody. Yay! Good evening, good evening, good evening, good evening. Oh my God, I am so overwhelmed. I am really honored. I have to follow protocol because, you know, I'm the one who always have to ensure that protocol is followed. So I do have a vote of thanks at the end, but I really must acknowledge my mom, my bishop, my London crew, especially because it's sleepy time. It's sleepy time, and I know my crew. That's when you know you have really good people in your life, that they just know that it might be late, but it's Wendy. It might be late, but it's Wendy. It might be late, but that's my sister. I could be watching cable, but that's my child. That's my minister. That's my friend. That's my sister. That's everything. So I really want to say thank you to Ishale. Well, I know as Penny, right? So I want to say thank you to Penny, who's doing an amazing job thus far. I'm seeing my crew from all over the world. This is just amazing. I'm seeing London, St. Martin, St. Lucia, Connecticut, New York, South Africa, I don't know, Dominica, Barbados. This is just amazing. I save you all money, actually, because think about if you had to travel to come to this. I save you all flight. I save some of you all accommodation. Beverly, you know, you just have to shop every time you travel and save your clothes. So you all ought to be really, really grateful. So at this point in time, I want to really be able to tell you all and to share with you all why I decided to give thanks, why I decided to do this way. And I want to walk you all through my journey. Some of you all would know some bits. Some of you all will be surprised by some things that may be shared. And I am going to be as brief as I can, although I am the queen of the night. But I really, really want to hear what everybody has to say in terms of the word that's coming from a powerful man of God and all the greetings, et cetera, et cetera. So, my darlings, everyone here is a darling tonight. I am going to share with you all my testimony, and I'm going to walk you through some stuff. And there's a song in between that I just want you guys to listen to the words of the song until we get, and I'm going to share my testimony in 5 parts. So I'm going to do a decade, but it's really short. The beginning, of course, doesn't have, just flow with me. I'm the queen of the night, so I have the mic, I have the floor, and I'm super duper excited about what God is doing in my life. I'm really excited about where I am. Somebody, my cousin, said to me today, "How do you feel?" I said, 50 and fabulous. I said, and she's a little younger than I am. I said, "When I'm finished with my testimony, you'll want to race to 50 because there's some grace with 50. There's some things that happen when you hit 50. And I could now relate to my friends like Beverly and they who had an amazing time when they hit 50. And I was like, "Beverly, I love you to death. You're my friend for life. You're like family, but I ain't too hurry to get to this 50 with you, huh?" And now here I am, really excited. So I'm going to share my journey with you all and just take a listen.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness
God.
Yeah. All my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire in darkest night. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. Oh, yes, yes. You have.
I needed to pause. So I gave you all the first 4 decades of my life in a nutshell, but I need to talk you through when I hit 40. I needed, this is really part of my journey. So you would have seen, I want to thank God for, you know, sometimes if you have a plant and you don't water the plant, it won't grow. So I see my life like a plant. So when my dad, who has left us for the past 10 years, this year was 10 years since my dad has gone to yonder, and I miss him every day, and this would have been an auspicious occasion for him. But I give God thanks and praise for the seed. And I thank my mom because she didn't have to decide to carry the seed. You see, sometimes we underestimate mothers and we underestimate women because you have to make a conscious decision to carry the seed. So I want to thank God for my dad for the seed and for my mom that made a decision to carry the seed. Because some of you all won't know, but my mom wanted to have one child, just one. And she said, yeah, she wanted to have one child. Put in the place. It's my dad who wanted to have the one child. So I apologize.
Cuts wanted four.
That's true. Right. Yes, correct. So daddy wanted one child and daddy wanted a daughter. But then purchase came first. So negotiations had to take place between mommy and daddy. And mommy said, I need to go for a girl because the four wasn't really working out well with daddy. So daddy agreed with mommy that we're going to go one more time. And if you get that girl, that's it. And if the girl had come first, she would have been called Michelle. And of course, the girl didn't come first. Curtis came, and then I came. So a conscious decision was made. And they didn't realize that when that seed was being planted, what that seed would have gone through, what that seed would have become. And I really thank God for my journey. My secondary school life, I have friends on this life from secondary school. I don't underestimate that word friendship. I have people here from secondary school. They're going to be talking later. And it just goes to show that when you have a true friend, real friends who stick with you throughout every season of your life, that's enough to give God thanks. When you have family members that stuck with you, they have to put up with you. They don't have much choice. Because, you know, it's blood. But when friends stick with you through thick and thin, through everything, your ups, your downs, your good days, your bad days, the days when you don't even feel like talking, they just understand you. I have friends on this live that just understand me. I don't have new friends, which is interesting. I might have new acquaintances, but I have friends who are like family, and I really appreciate each and every one of you all from across the globe. My entertainment journey, I spent 30 years in entertainment. I have zero regrets. I've learned so much. I've had people in entertainment. Lisa Wickham is on this live. I met her in entertainment. We're still friends today. I have my brother from another mother who's on this live. You may know him as Magadan. You might know him as Maximus Dan, but he's now MX Prime. I call him Max. He's my brother from another mother. So I met some really awesome people throughout my journey, including entertainment. And when I hit 40, I was like, that's when I lost my dad, actually. 2 weeks before my 40th birthday, we would have buried my dad. And then life took a different turn. Wasn't a bad turn, but it was a turn that made me realize, and it was yesterday when I was saying, you know, how are you going to share this testimony? How are you going to tell people about your journey? And I started zeroing in on the number 40. And, you know, 40 symbolizes a period of testing. So I don't deny any of the tests that I've been through, because the test would have given me a testimony. Because during Moses's life, you know, he lived 40 years in Egypt and 40 years in the desert before God selected him to lead his people out of slavery. So sometimes when you're going through your testing, it's the period before you get selected. And God have to do some chipping. He have to do some chipping and some carving and some grooming. Moses was also on Mount Sinai for 40 days and nights and on two separate occasions. And he also sent spies for 40 days to investigate the land God promised the Israelites. So sometimes that period when you're 40, that 10-year period between 40 and 50, you will have some tests that are going to turn into testimonies. I've been in the valley. And if you picture a valley, you might be worrying and you might be fretting when you're going down. But when you're going down, if you know who you are and you know whose you are, you'll just think about the next bit when you have to come up. Because once you go down the valley, you must come up. So I really thank God for my journey in terms of being 40. You know, the prophet Ezekiel, he laid on his right side for 40 days to symbolize stuff. Elijah went 40 days without food or water. That period was really a testing time, and God groomed me. I've made so many changes in my life. I have grown. I must say so myself. I have grown. And then I had an encounter. I think that's the best way to put it. And my journey started shifting, and I started eradicating religion and forming a relationship with God. There were many men and women of God that contributed to my spiritual journey. And I know Pastor Tricia from the United States is here.
Yes, honey. On
the program to speak at some...
They ain't get through. The policeman called them and tell them. When they want to leave, they ain't come outside.
I need to mute these people.
She says she did.
Thank you, my Lord. Okay. So Pastor Tricia has significant role in my spiritual journey. She's someone, she lived in London with me as well, my whole London crew. And she's going to be talking later. Some significant things happened in terms of my testing when I was in London. And I just want to share one of the things. Some of you all may know, I know for sure Penny knows about this. And you know, sometimes when God have a call on your life, you may know at the time, or you may not even know. I mean, I grew up in church. I know about Sunday school, teaching Sunday school and all the rest of it. So I understood religion. And it's not until I had an encounter and I began to understand what a relationship with God really means and what a relationship with God should really be doing, is when I started looking at life differently. So I'm just gonna stop the share so that you all can see me full screen for the moment, because at the end of the day, I really want you all to understand some of the things and some of the reasons why I don't have a choice but to say thank you. So I was living in London, and for those my Londoners will understand this bit, during the winter, making sure that I drive, and during the summer, I never used to drive because you could take public transport and the place is hot. And I was coming home one evening, and I have to come off the tube and then get a bus. I was living in Chingford at the time. And when I came off the tube, there are two buses I can take to get home. each of the two buses are like 3 minutes apart. So if you miss one, there's a next one. And it's not Trinidad. If the bus says 6 o'clock, it's 6 o'clock. So when I came off the train and I approached the bus stop, the bus drove off. And this guy said to me, if you just go through the alleyway, you can catch the bus, you know. Yes, I still have my British accent. And I said, no, it's fine. There's another bus in 3 minutes. And he was adamant. He was saying, no, you just cut through the alleyway. I'm telling you, you can grab the bus. And I looked at him and I thought, why is he so adamant? I could wait on the bus. And I just waited. The next bus came, and I've always been a reader. Everybody who knows me knows I'm always reading. So I jumped on the bus, the second bus, and I remember I was reading a book by Ian Van Zandt called In the Meantime, that Penny actually gave me for my birthday years ago. And I'm on the bus reading my book. And on my left, at the time I didn't know, but there was a Jamaican girl. And you must know your journey home. So I realized that I'm driving, but we're taking too long to get to my stop. So I lift my head up the same time with the Jamaican girl. So she said, drive away, you are go, because we were off route completely. And I'm like, where are we going? And then the driver made an announcement and he said, I have to take another route, but don't worry, I'm going to get back on track. Is anybody going before, I think it was Chingford train station, and everybody said no, so he had to divert. So I'm back in my book because I'm not far from the station. When he got to the top of the hill, which is where I can now get to go home, I'm just seeing all these flashing lights. Flashing lights, flashing lights. I'm like, okay, something clearly happening. So I came off the bus, people. And when I came off the bus, there's like a lamp pole. I just held onto the bus, the pole, because my legs just gave away. Because the bus that I did not get on was wrapped around the post. And I just couldn't speak. A man came out of store. He's like, mommy, okay? I couldn't speak. And I said, you know what? What if I had gotten on that bus? We would not be here today. The bus was wrapped around the post. The driver died on the spot. And I was the last stop, so I would have been on the bus. So I know that I have a lot to give thanks for. I remember London, Penny and I lived in the same house for years. And we have the same temperament when coming to stuff like school and work. Yes, Prophet has delayed, but not denied. And there was a morning, Penny could remember, I woke up and I said, I'm not going to work today. And I don't miss work. And I said, I think we should just take a chill out day, yes? So we just stayed home just so, was Penny's response. I was like, yeah, why we can't just stay home? I just got up and heard a voice that said to me, stay home. Now, at that time, I didn't know that it was called discernment. I didn't know any of those things. And we stayed home. And Penny will remember that was the morning when they had the bombing in central London. We were home. We were home and we both worked in central London. We would have been smack bang in the middle of everything. Fast forward to Trinidad. In my entertainment days, I went to, some of you all would know Impulse, who is a very good friend of mine. I went to this event by Impulse and I was living in Arima at the time and I'm driving up the highway with my boyfriend at the time. And just by the Freeport Bridge, there was like water that settled during the day. And I was driving my Corolla and my Corolla picked up that water and pitched my vehicle up in the air. All I remembered is a voice that said to me, you will live and not die. So I just got a calmness in my spirit. And that car spin, flip head down into a ditch. And I was like, I was asking him if he okay. He wasn't talking. None of us were talking. I was like, the first thing I said was Jesus. And he said to me, baby, all right? I said, I'm all right. You all right? He said, I think so. He said, you don't move. This was heaven for those of you all who would know that part of my life. And heaven came out and he opened the door. He said, don't move. Make sure you're feeling okay enough to move. Well, of course, people start to stop and everybody arrived in the ditch. And I said to him, I could move. He said, you sure? I said, yes, I could move. So I came out. Now remember, the car tilted on this side. So I had to climb through the window. I climbed through the window. And Penny's one of my best friends. I have best friends on this call. And one thing people know, Marty Curtis, my aunt, everybody know, I am boss with numbers. I will remember numbers. I can tell, look, my aunt is shaking her head. Numbers, I don't forget numbers. I could remember people's telephone number from primary school. I could remember birthdays from in primary school. And the bridge that I flipped by is like about 5 minutes from Penny's house. And I cannot remember Penny's number. Heaven is like, but, and Penny, I said, I can't remember the number. Now my phone, dumping water, my handbag flip. So my phone, everything cat's cradle. But Heaven's phone was in his jacket pocket. So he was able to use his phone, but I can't remember the number. I said, wow, who to call? I said, doesn't make sense calling mommy because she gonna panic. By this time, police reach, ambulance reach, everybody reach. My car is like a complete write-off. So the officer walked up to us and said, the ambulance left with the victims from this. So I'm looking at him. He said, the driver gone? So I said, no. He said, so the ambulance, well, hold up, because the ambulance had to go with the driver, because I said, no. The driver is fine. He said, Miss Lady, this guy's a write-off. Who is the driver? So he looking now, because people, there's other guys sitting down on the floor trying to make calls. It was just chaos. And I looked at him and I said, I'm the driver. He said, no, the driver, this car. I said, I'm the driver. He said, Miss Lady, you the driver, this car here, you know, this car in the ditch, this car. So my boyfriend said, yeah, she's the driver. We both were in the vehicle. He said, whoever that God is, you need to hold on to that God, because there ain't no way anybody's supposed to survive this. By this time, I said, okay. He said, you need to go in the ambulance. I said, no, I feel fine. Heaven is like, you sure? I said, I'm fine. I feel fine. So then Heaven's brother came and they organized the rector and stuff. And by this time we decided, okay, let's call Kathleen, because media started to arrive. Next thing Kathleen see this thing on the news and there's a whole drama. So we ended up calling mommy and saying, mommy, I got in an accident, but I'm fine. You sure? I said, mommy, I'm fine. I said, we waited for Heaven's brother. The wrecker came and whatnot. And I went home. And there were so many times that I could not have been here. I have enough to say thank you, Jesus, for all my pits that I was in. I found purpose, all my valley experiences. And then I got rid of religion and I started seeing God in a brand new way. And then I entered prophetic ministry and I started understanding what prophetic ministry was all about. I met some amazing people. Sister Shelley from Mahanaim is on this live. People from prophetic ministry. Prophet E.J. Adetomawa would have been instrumental in teaching me how to really understand the art and the power of prayer. Pastor Trisha and I were friends before we even recognized that there were calls in our lives, and we entered the spiritual realm together. And then members of my family started getting ordained, after two of my aunts, and I'm like, this is an interesting journey. And God started moving and shifting and things started happening. And I was never too religious to forget, I was never too spiritual to forget where I came from. And I just started sharing my experiences with everybody in my immediate circle. All my friends knew when the switch happened, as I was still doing stuff with my friends. I never denied anything. And I came out of ministry. I listened, I heard come out. I was very obedient and I came out of ministry and I made up in my mind, not me and church people. I want to say it like that. This is not a British statement, not me and church people. I make up my mind. I told mommy, say, what is this? I said, mommy, not me. I have a relationship with God. Jamal Brandt is my friend. I'm tuning into my boy Jamal. I go hop a plane and go to Atlanta and see Jamal's church, which I did. I love my TD Jakes. I went to Atlanta to women that were loose. Not me and church people. But when God put a call on your life, some strange things happen. So I was home one night and I have known, I think it's 2012 or 2013 is when I would have known Bishop Dexter James, who you will see in a moment. So I've known him from back then. So I had my notifications on and the lights were off. I was literally in my bed and I heard the ping about live. So I picked up my phone and I looked at the phone and I saw Dexter James going live. I put down the phone and I say, you know what? Just press the thing. And I pressed it. And there was a service going on. And I heard a voice in the service that sounded very familiar. So I said, but I know this voice. This is Prophet Barnin. Prophet Barnin in Trinidad. So then I made a phone call and I realized there's one more night. Actually, the conference was supposed to end. And it got extended for one more night. And I went to Princeton Ministry. And I saw Prophet Barnin, who's a powerful man of God as well. And he started speaking. And he just looked at me and started prophesying. And he said, and he pointed and he said, this is the man of God that you need to be under. Now, I always knew about him. I always heard about him. Very respectful, reputable man of God. But I was away from church. So I took all of that into my head and I said, you know what, I have to pray about this because church people think. And I did. I fight, I argue, I make up my, because you guys know my personality strong. And if I make up my mind, I make up my mind. I ain't going, I ain't moving, I ain't nothing. And then God started speaking to me and said, you know what, there's a call on your life. And the prophetic word, you could test the word and I test the word. And I met an amazing man of God who saw in me what a lot of people saw in me, but refused to identify. So it wasn't that a lot of people didn't see it. And not only did he recognize the gifts that I was carrying, he started to pour into me in a different way. And he started sharing stuff with me about my journey. And he started speaking to me from a very prophetic place. And I realized, this is not normal. This have God in it. And God started talking to me personally. He started talking to him concerning me. And strange enough, there are a lot of things that Bishop would have said to me that would have been confirmation that I already heard from God. So it wasn't a case of, I just ran with a word. So which is why I had to put up this slide because a lot of work has been done on me. A lot of chiseling had to take place before I had to be recognized and come into the woman of God that I am. I'm now an ordained minister. I love the Lord with my whole heart. My life has shifted completely. And I don't want to say too much more because I really want the man of God to speak. But my journey has had some ups and downs, some hurdles, some tests, some trials, some tribulations. But listen to me, if I only knew that coming to 50 will give me the relationship with God that I now have, and everything that I've walked into, I would have ran to 50, but then I would have missed out my journey and I would have missed out on my purpose. So I really want to say that this chiseling here, I was trying to look for a picture that have less fat, but some more chiseling took place physically, spiritually, and I really thank God for my journey. So 40 is super significant. I want to thank God for my man of God. I'll be back to introduce him shortly. But at this point in time, I don't want to talk too long. I want to hand the floor over to Ishele Robinson Cooper, AKA Pennywise. Everybody had a nickname. Once you are wrong me, you will get a nickname. So Penny, my dear, where are thou?
Where I am. I'm here, right here.
You're here. So over to you, my dear. Yes. Over to you. I will say some more in my voter thanks. I have to leave something for the voter thanks.
Much, Wendy. I think that was, yes, that was an excellent testimony. Thank you for reminding me of some of our wonderful days in London. Never a dull moment. Never a dull moment. And okay, so right now we want to, we have a series of greeting corners, and this is the first one. So I'm going to call on persons to give some greetings, and if they are not here, we'll just move on to the next one. So first of all, I want to call on Auntie Kathleen, who is the mother of the celebrant, to bring greetings to your wonderful daughter, Wendy.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. to the man of God, Bishop and Prophet Dr. Dexter Jameson, distinguished guests, friends and family, pleasant good evening. Special good evening to the lady at the moment, my daughter. Wendy, I am thanking God for his love, mercy, and grace toward you. He has kept you to reach this milestone, your 50th birthday. You are wonderfully and beautifully made. Give God the praise and honor that is due to his matchless name. On the 14th of July, 1971, you came into this world a bouncing baby girl, 9 pounds, 1 ounce and a half. Wendy Hazel and Lewis, your names were given to you by your father, who is now deceased. He would have been very proud of you today. I can hear him saying in his fatherly tone, "This is my daughter, you know." But I believe he's watching over you right now with pride and joy in his heart. I thank God for you on this, your 50th birthday. From infancy, Wendy has been a talker. Never answer a question with one word, must give a full sentence. She was and still is a disciplined child. At school, Wendy was a brilliant student. All her test reports read, very bright student, excellent work, well-behaved child, etc. But the last line at the end of those reports, every class teacher had a similar chorus. If Wendy will talk less, this child talks too much. She's always talking in class. So whenever Wendy will bring her report home, I always look at the last line, hoping that one day I will see something different. But never, always Wendy talks too much. I guess this is a gift that you were born with, because now you're talking for your living. So keep on doing what you love best and keep going on. If I may say so myself, you're doing a good job.
Thank you.
I thank God for the woman you have become. You are caring, confident, ambitious, intelligent, passionate, and conscientious person. I pray that God will continue to bless, guide, and protect you, will grant you the desires of your heart. Always remember to keep God first in your life. Love God, love yourself, and love others. And finally, do unto others as you have them do unto you, and always remember to do good. God loves you, I love you, and I'm proud to have you as my daughter. Happy 50th birthday. Stay sweet today.
Thank you, Mommy.
God bless.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Auntie Kathleen, for those lovely
words. You're welcome.
And now I would like to go to the brother of the celebrant, Curtis Lewis, who's joining us from Toronto. Over to you, Curtis.
Thank you, Penny. Good evening, everyone, family, and friends, and well, even people I don't even know. Hi, I'm Wendy's brother, Curtis. Wendy.
Hey.
Happy birthday! We had a dialogue this morning. I told you what I had to tell you. I didn't have a speech written out. I gave a big spiel this morning, but for those who wasn't there, here's a synopsis. A little synopsis. You know, I am not the talker in the family. Wendy is the talker in the family. I is the more laid back, quiet person. I like to do things on the scene, but you know, anyways, Wendy, one thing I could tell you when I told you this morning, I'm going to tell you again. I am absolutely proud of you in terms of your growth. But and when I say growth, we as family, as brother, sister, I know family members alone will know this. We had tough times, but as we grow older, at this the age bring reason and understanding. And I am, as I say, I'm proud of you, of your achievements, everything that you're doing today and gathering in your life, you're going to get it abundantly as time goes. I'm proud of you. I'm very, and the moments that we have when we speak and we have these deep conversations about life and about your program and all that kind of stuff. And I remember telling you, start the radio program. Is I who tell you to do that? You forget? Yes. So I'm proud. I'm proud that you listen to your big brother and you're making steps in your life and reaching big, big goals and achievements. And I'm very proud of you. Happy birthday. And I wish you many, many, many more years of joy, peace, success, and happiness.
Thank you so much. Love you loads.
Love you too. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Curtis. Sad as only Curtis could say. No way, brother. But good to see you and good to hear you.
Yes, darling. Nice. Likewise.
I would like to move now to Wendy's other brother. Is he on the call? Is Marlon on the call?
That's what I'm trying to see. Curtis, check and see if Marlon on the call. I check in too.
Okay.
Oh, you call his name?
Yes, Marlon, if you are on the call.
Marlon, Nicole, Marlon, New Jersey.
No, okay, well, we can come back.
You'll come back to Marlon. Go ahead, Pen.
Okay, and the next person I want to find out if Angela Charles is on the call, who is Wendy's UK-based mom.
Scroll.
If Angela Charles is on the call or anyone related to Angela Charles.
Go to the London crew.
I'm not hearing, so right. So now we're getting into the London crew, because I know you're all up and awake. I've seen Marty looking like she's about to bap out there. But I know your eyes just small. I know your eyes small. I only joke.
You're looking to get both from Marty.
Oh, Lord. Let's start foolishness now.
So I want to start with Beverly, Charmaine, Tony. If you would like to bring greetings to the birthday girl, the mic is and the floor is yours. You're on mute, hon. You need to unmute yourself.
Hi, everybody. Wendy, I sat here thinking, what to say? Because it's 20 years and more of memories in London. You want the monarch.
Yes.
When I came back, it's to say, Gail is your night tonight, you're taking it, and the joy, it's just too much. It's too much memories here, memories in Trinidad, and the journey has been a wonderful one. I thank God that he sent you into my life in London, because you took me through everything in London. So you talk about Chingford, and I remember many Christmases at that house in Chingford, and birthday parties, and I could go on and on and on and on and still go on. You know, the parties in Trinidad. Wendy, you have been such a huge, as I sit here, such a huge part of my life that sometimes you take the people who are with you through these years for granted, because they're always there. The land in Trinidad, we there. And it's just so much. I wish you many more years. I haven't actually been with you in Trinidad to understand this part of your journey, because I am here and you are there. But I know that when we do connect, you will fill me in the blanks, and then we will be as though we didn't even have a moment away from each other. I love you, you know that. And you have been there for me, I have been there for you. And you just continue being you, continue being the wonderful person that you are. And as I sit here, I think so many memories, and I could go on and on, but I know there's a lot of people to talk. So happy birthday, darling.
Thank you so much. Continue to be you. Thank you so, so much. I just want to say one thing with Beverly. I remember when I entered the Calypso Monarch for real, and there was a break, and Beverly just ran in the back. He's like, you win. I said, but they have more people to sing. The competition not over. She said, I tell you, you win tonight. You win. And when I became the first woman to win the Calypso Monarch, Beverly does my makeup, organize my clothes. Girl, it's real memories. I love you. And thank you so much. Thank you.
Beverly, and thank you to Wendy. Wonderful words about a history of friendship that is ongoing.
I'd like the record to state I'd like my makeup to last. Please?
Yes, all right. You better put on some more because you have plenty crying to do. I'm calling on Pauline Lewis. Is Pauline on the call?
I didn't check.
Okay, if she's not, I want to go over to Marty Caballero to bring greetings to the birthday girl. Over to you, Marty.
Myself, let me unmute myself. Well, Wendy girl, as you alone could have me up at this hour. Eh? thank God that I'm off tomorrow. What can I say? As Beverly said, when I came to London, Wendy was one of the first people that I met, and she made me feel so welcome. And the strangest thing is that when we went by Mommy Angela, I didn't even realize that Mommy Angela's husband was a teacher together with my mom. So everything is family. Wendy is like my family. She's like my sister. Curtis, my brother, he say he quiet, but he ain't quiet no bit. I know what he talking about. But Wendy girl, welcome.
Yes, darling.
I am quiet.
I wish you all the best. All the best. God's greatest blessings upon you, my darling.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
No problem, my sweetheart.
And I know the London crew, I know if you guys need to slip out, it's fine. I understand because it's 1 o'clock in the morning. So I understand, definitely. But that's why I put the London crew first.
Okay, thank you so much, Marty. It falls to me now just to say a few more words. I just want to point out some consistencies in the greetings, you know, that Wendy showed everybody London because she was one of the people who was there before some of us arrived. So she had a history and a tradition of showing everybody London, myself included. The funny thing is, I think I met Curtis before I met Wendy.
Yes, because Curtis and Roger are friends.
Roger, my brother and Curtis were friends. I met Curtis first, and then I met Wendy. And I'll never forget, the first day Wendy came to Ilford, I was just like, yeah, I like you. You all right. I can line with you. Because I am also a talker, and the confidence and the willingness to show people around London, because arriving in London from Trinidad or from anywhere else is not necessarily an easy transition. So if you have somebody who you can relate to, you can show you the ropes and help you to understand the systems of the guests around where places to get things done and myself. Another thing I would like to say is her openness, the openness of her heart. Sometimes I have to buffer and say, oh God, everybody is not to pick up. But her openness, I know that God will bless her. So many people, myself included, have lived at her various houses for different periods of time. You know, there's never a dull moment. From the time we reach my venue, gosh, you know, I have to move out to student accommodation. I have to figure it out. And I'm not getting up. Well, come here. You can stay here. You know, many people, she has said that, both in Trinidad and in the UK. I know if ever I'm in a bind for whatever reason, whether she's in the country or not, she will make it happen. I have a home at her, as she has a home at me. And I want to acknowledge, Wendy, your openness and your kindness. Sometimes it is not reciprocated. And I see the bewilderment on your face when you see how close some people can be and how mean-spirited some people can be, even in light of your open, you know, presence and your love that you try to share. But the love that you share transcends that. You need to be assured of that. I know you know it probably in your right brain, but sometimes in your left brain, you try to make sense of foolish things you've done. Don't make no sense. You just have to leave those people to the Lord, as you well know. But your love, your caring, your openness, your hospitality, your willingness to always help has not gone unnoticed. It is in fact one of your most endearing qualities. And like the others who spoke before me, I love you and I wish you all the best, and always know that I am here for you. And happy birthday.
Thank you, my darling.
Welcome. Okay, I'm going back into my MC mode now. We have a poem from Aisha Manrique.
Or Manrique.
Manrique.
Hi. Good evening, hi, everyone. Aisha.
Right.
All right. Wendy. Well, before I give this little tribute, I must say, I don't know, I got a bit emotional because whilst listening to you, my mother, Cheryl Chacha, may her soul rest in peace, I know you were very dear to her. And I was just hearing mommy, it's almost as if I felt her presence here and just looking at you and beaming and smiling and saying, yes, Wendy, tell them, share that story, Wendy. Because I remember attending events with my mom and or looking at a program on television. And if my mother was to pick up a bad verb or subject verb agreement doesn't fall in place or where it's supposed to be, I remember my mother would say, and she would start to complain, and I would be, oh gosh, mommy, they made a mistake. Okay, all right. And then she would say, Aisha, you just don't understand. You see me, let me call Wendy. She's the only person I could relate to on these things. So on behalf of you, you know, right? You're not talking the truth. So on behalf of mommy and I, we really want to wish you a happy birthday, darling. And I hope that you enjoy this little tribute that I ensure that I put pen to paper to write today, because I know if I don't do it, it won't be nice. So here goes. Putting pen to paper to create this piece was a compelling experience, to say the least. Conceptualizing this message I'm about to share about our Wendy, I had to take great care. You see, because Wendy, our Wendy, is no ordinary Wendy. Our Wendy, if you know, you know. In those high heels, she's stepping in fine style. While others fighting to take two steps, oh, darling, she can strut a few miles. And don't get me started with her demeanor and class. Where's the event, you say? Let's just say when she makes her entrance, please step aside so she can pass. But I say this from a humble perspective, ladies and gentlemen. Please don't get me wrong, because Wendy is a genuine, helpful soul. And if you give her a chance, she'll talk about God and protocol all day long. Her passion, that driving force, her purpose in order to fulfill. She'll turn day into night, night into day because of that determination and will. Wendy, you've persevered and achieved great things, but your journey has just begun. So continue to stay encouraged, my darling, because any battle you face is already won. Today is your special day. Look around you, see and feel how blessed you are, because you and I both know the intangible is where it's at, not just about the house or the car. So as we gather here this evening to enjoy your special moment and see you all fulfilled and happy, I say happy, happy birthday to you, dear Wendy, and the best of Jubilee. We love you, darling.
Thank you very much for that wonderful poem.
Thank you, Aisha. Oh my God. Thank you so, so much. Thank you.
You're most welcome, darling.
Okay, so we're moving on now to our second greeting corner. Wendy, I don't think the first two people are here. So
I'm you're going to Donovan.
Yes. So I would like to call on the Chawi representative, Rondell Donovan. Is Rondell on the call?
Yes, he is.
Okay, over to you, Rondell.
Good evening and good morning, according to where in the world you are.
Good morning.
Wendy.
Yes, sir.
Lucy, I know I'm speaking on behalf of the board of directors of the Caribbean Women's and Honors.
Rondell, let me mute everybody. And now you can come back on, Rondell. Rondell, you can unmute.
Yes.
Right, go ahead.
This evening, I'm speaking in my capacity as director of the Caribbean Women Honors and Empowerment, Trinidad and Tobago chapter. Wendy Lewis, our chairman, chief cook and bottle washer, as we call them. Wendy, we want to wish you a happy, happy 50th birthday. I mean, 50th in numbers, but of course, 30 in spirit. You are an amazing soul. One thing, Wendy, when she sets out to do something, she gets it done, regardless of whether you are on board or not, right? She sets her agenda, she sets her timelines, and it gets done, even if it's a solo job. I've met Wendy in London when I lived there, when I was a student. And you know, Wendy being the Calypso singer, monarch, me also being part of the Calypso tent in London, it was extraordinary times. And seeing Wendy came back to Trinidad doing her stuff, being anointed by the Spirit of God in everything that she does. You know, we want to say that we appreciate you, we congratulate you on this milestone. Not many people these days are seeing these type of milestone, particularly during this unprecedented time. So we thank God for you. And we hope that you continue to build your empire from strength to strength, that God continue to cover you with his grace, with his love, with his guidance, with his power, with his mercies. And just continue being the wonderful person that you are, the God-fearing individual. And of course, just continue being Wendy. We know who is Wendy, and once we accept who is Wendy, we can get along.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much.
So again, on behalf of all of us at Chawi, we wish you happy birthday, and we are grateful for this moment. So happy birthday, Wendy.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rondell, for that. Is there Camille Halls on the call?
No, she left to write her exam. She'll be back though.
Oh, okay. So now we're going to have a musical interlude by Sister Beverly Joseph. Is Beverly on the call? Beverly Joseph is saying, not Beverly.
The Beverly
Joseph.
I say a pleasant good afternoon to the esteemed guests, because I know that God is in the midst of all of this. A pleasant good afternoon to the birthday girl. A pleasant good afternoon to the bishop, to all those in their own diversities of gifts and ranks. It is indeed a pleasure for me to be here on this spot of ground at this point in time here. Today we celebrate with you for life. We celebrate a journey. Some of us have been in it from the beginning. Some of us have been in it, you know, along the way. But through it all, you have people that has been a part of your journey. And that's what life is. Life is a journey that we meet and we greet. Some come in our lives for a reason, some come for a season. And, you know, I just thank God for you. I really, really do thank God for you. I thank God for your ministry. I thank God for the way that he has molded you and he continues to mold you and make you to what he wants you to be. For many a times, you know, we have directives in our pathway and we do things because we feel it's all about us. But then, you know, when God really has a hand on you, then, you know, you're shaped and becomes in a different meter. And when it turns around, sometimes, you know, we look back and we say, yes, God is truly an amazing God that he has brought you from this far. And, you know, you are here at present. So, you know, today is really a nice day. You know, Wendy, I know you for a couple of years. Well, I wouldn't speak too much on our journey because everybody has a journey with you. But, you know, I thank God for the space that we have occupied and we continue to occupy. So, you know, I didn't know, you know, really it was just to bring a little greeting. But, you know, one of the things I want to tell you is, I know the Lord would make a way for you. I know the Lord would make a way for you. If you live a holy life, shun the wrong and do what's right. I know the Lord would make a way for you. I know the Lord would make a way for you. I know the Lord would make a way for you. If you live a holy life, shun the wrong and do what's right. I know the Lord would make a way for you. For he touched you. Oh, he touched you. And all the joys that filled your soul. Something happened. And now I know he touched you and made you whole. He touched you. Oh, he touched you. And all the joy that fills your soul, something happened, and now I know he touched you and me. You so I know the Lord would make a way for you. I know the Lord would make a way for you. If you live a holy life, shun the wrong and do what's right. I know the Lord would make a way for you. Happy birthday, my princess. I love you, love you, love you from the moon back. You know that. And though the journey may be tedious, I want you to have faith and just continue trusting God and continue pressing forward.
Love Thank you. You so, so, so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you for that wonderful song, Sister Beverly Joseph, and indeed a beautiful voice.
Pen, can I interject?
Yes.
I know we're going into the word next, but my cousin from Atlanta is in Jamaica and has to go into transit, so she wants to do her greeting so that she can leave.
Sure.
That's my cousin Katrina from Atlanta.
Katrina. Hi, everyone.
Hey, cuz.
Hey, hon. Hi, daddy. I see you, but you are not seeing me. But I see daddy's on, Wendy.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, but he's not seeing me. I've been trying to forget his attention. But I am very grateful for the opportunity to share a little bit tonight. And one of the things that I am grateful for, besides the opportunity, is the fact that you've transitioned from the worldly affairs to your father's business. And as I hear you give your testimonies, it's our testimonies that remind us who we are, where we've come from, and where we're going, that we were created with a purpose. And when you listen to your friends, you're a leader, right? So now that you've walked into your calling, lead those who have not yet gotten the opportunity to have that relationship that you speak about with Christ. It's never too late. I am so glad to hear that after all is said and done, the product, some to know that that's the God we serve, that at the end of the day, he will leave the 99 and come after that one. And I know that your heart is full of joy to know that at that point in time, when you made the transition, you were that one, the apple of his eye, that he said, I need to go get my daughter. I've gifted her, I've called her, and it's time. So it's really a blessing to share this moment with you. It's an honor. You know, we talk, and you are, you know, we are plenty cousins, but you know how it is. You and I and Curtis, we kind of feel like this is the cousin group right here. All of them thousands, right?
So right, true. Curtis?
So it's really a blessing to call you not only cousin, but sister, because we have a father that we're going to meet in heaven one day. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep reaching for the stars. The sky is the limit, sister. Lead for God. Represent him and lead for God. As you've shown others London and they're grateful, show others who God is. Because without him, we are nothing. We can do nothing. And as you hear from him, even when he talked about the accident and he protected you and stuff, you know, continue to give your testimony to others, and it would take root in their heart, and they would know, hey, if Wendy could go through that and make it, I'm right behind her. So continue, my love. God bless you. I know that God is making me. Your friend sang, I know the Lord will make a way. He's continuing to make ways. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what he has in store for you, because the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come. So continue along God's journey, and happy 50th birthday. They say in Atlanta, turn up, but we turning up in Jesus, right?
Amen.
So turn up with the Lord. All right. Bless you, love. Good night, hon.
Thank you. Love you, Lord. Have a safe trip.
Love
we
you.
We will chat. Okay.
Hi, right. Patrina.
Hello, Patrina.
Love you,
Curtis.
Love you.
Patrina, I just wanted to say hello to you before you leave the call. It's Cavell.
Hey, this world too small. You two know each other?
Yes.
Okay, we'll have this conversation after.
Very well. Very, very well.
Safe travels.
Thank you. Bye, guys. God bless you all.
Bye. Love you. Bye.
Thanks,
Patrina.
Love you, cuz. Love you, cuz.
Love you, cuz.
Right, so Wendy, I want to give the floor back to you now so that you can introduce Bishop Dr. Dexter James. Over to you, Wendy.
I can. Good evening to Apostle Diane Wilson, my mom, my bishop, the fivefold ministry from Warriors Assembly that's represented, all my cousins, family, friends, everyone. I couldn't do this Thanksgiving without my bishop. I couldn't have anyone else, you know, bring the word in this Thanksgiving. Bishop has been an instrumental part in my journey. He has been an instrumental part in my journey. He has recognized stuff that God has placed in my life. I am eternally grateful to the call for him answering the call on his life. You know, and I want to say, as I introduce this amazing man of God who carries a very strong anointing, he has a healing ministry. He's a prophet, he's an apostle. He really is a shepherd to his flock. And before I introduce him, I just want to tell him, thank you so much. Thank you so much for seeing everything that you saw in me. And I don't want to discount anybody that didn't see. I think it was for you to see. I think you were supposed to benefit from what I have and what I'm carrying. I thank God for our covenant. I thank God for the word that he is about to use you to bring forth. And I really want to bless God for you. And I want to take this opportunity to introduce everyone on this live to my apostle, my bishop, my doctor, my spiritual father, my friend for life. And I say that without apologies, my anchor, because sometimes when the seas are rough, the only time you could be able to steady the storm is if you have an anchor. So at this point in time, I'd like to introduce Apostle Bishop Dr. Dexter James. Bishop? This Bishop.
Thank you so much, Minister Wendy. Pleasant evening to you and happy 50th birthday. And I know you're enjoying the day. Nice background, nice birthday thing. And I want to say pleasant evening to all those on the panel and all the good thing they have said. And I know none is lie because the little time I know you. All right. But I love mommy's speech, you know. I was laughing. I'm glad it was on mute because you all would I hear my laugh at mommy say, everything was okay. The only thing they say on every report, I looked at the end of the report, she talks too much. And you know, and mom said that, but it's so important that we can discern people calling from small. So sometimes, instead of telling children, shut them out, we had to make sure to say the right thing with their mouth. Sometimes it's just to steer people, purpose in the right direction, but I'm glad. God bless you, mommy, for doing a good job. And I know you contribute a lot, but she looking so, because she said every Sunday she used to come by you and eat. So your food have a looking. All right, so let us go. The number 50 in scripture, it speaks of jubilee. It also speaks of favor. It speaks about the year of release of burdens and debt and all those different things. It is really a number of transition. It's a number of transition. And it also speaks of restoration. So things that have been lost the last 50 years of your life, in this season, in this new phase, God is going to restore those things that need to be restored. I want to share on something for a short while, and I'm going to talk prophetically to you this evening. I really believe people birth means something on the earth. There's nobody that come here by accident. There's nobody come here by accident. So I heard Apostle Diane Wilson, when she prayed, she mentioned it. I said, my mom jumped in my message. So I'm going to read 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 4 to 10, and I'm going to share from there. Coming to him as to a living stone, rejected indeed by men, but chosen by God and precious. You also, as living stones, are being built up a spiritual house, a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifice acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. Therefore, it is also contained in the scriptures. I'll just skip that. Let me go straight to verse 9. But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. And that should talk a lot about your testimony, who once were not a people, but are now the people of God, who had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. I want to share for a short while on a subject, chosen by God. Chosen by God. The scripture said we are chosen by him. One scripture said we didn't choose him, he chose us. And the reason why I really feel this is fitting, this is what I believe the Lord gave me to share with you, chosen by God. And even when I hear your testimony, some of the things I never heard, I didn't know you was the female MacGyver. So with all those accidents and all those different things, chosen by God. And I was looking at the meaning chosen because it is really fitting. It means having been selected as the best or the most appropriate. So when God select you to be the best at what he has graced you for. And the next one is one who is the object of choice or divine favor. You are God's choice. God has favored you. Because I'm going somewhere with this. An elect person. So you're not an accident on this planet. Because while people praise you for the last 50 years of your life, they will see the best part of the year, the next 20 years of your life and more. And number four, meaning selected for favor or special privilege. So when you are chosen, you are selected for favor and special privilege. God grace you for that. Now, so when we're talking about chosen, when were you chosen? When God understood that he need a Wendy on the earth? Because one of the things we have to understand, we are original. People try to make us copy, but if you try to copy somebody, then the people who need you to be you will not be blessed by you. So this, I love this, and I know you've heard me preach this many times, but I have to say it again. Psalms 139, verse 16, the New Living Translation said, you saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day has passed. That is why situation couldn't take you out. But the situation was recorded in the book. And please know, David didn't say the angels recorded. He said, you recorded. So there is not just a book of life concerning, when we talk about the book of life, there is a book concerning our life. And God has 50, this is, open out that book, and he wrote that book and saw this today. And to remind you, and I'm saying, your best days has not gone. Your best days, you enjoy something, but those things will compare to nothing to the season that God is taking you into. There are places that God can take you into because you need to understand certain things about people. Hmm. Because the cycle of your life, good is when bad is when it comes back on the next side. And your desire to see people change has become a great burden and a frustration when they do not change with the with what you offer that you know can bring about change. But go in your understanding that you're able to work to appreciate. Because every environment is not designed for you. Every environment is not designed for when, because your level is taunted. And you're strange, and that's okay. So then Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5. Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee as a prophet unto the nations. Because the question that you ask in God, where do I go from here? Because life has not been moving as fast as you wanted to move. But what didn't happen in 50 years could happen in 1 year with God, could happen in 1 month with God. Sometimes God takes long to prepare us for a short task. So you can leave somewhere early. Sorry, leave for somewhere early. But if you do not know where you're going, you can still end up late. If you know where you're going, you can leave late and still reach early. So you're not late for your future. I just feel that you're not late for your future. You're right on time. Everything was preparation for what God has for you. And I'm gonna get to that now, because you're not going to do to make something or prepare something. You're walking into something that God already prepared. So he chose you, watch Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10, New International Version. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. The New Living Translation have it this way. For we are God's masterpiece. I like that, because that means you are a piece of the master. I always like to say it like that. And he has created us anew in Christ Jesus so we can do the good things he planned for us long ago. So your life was already planned out before you came to this earth. And everything, as the scriptures say, and we know that all things work together for good to them who love God and who are called according to his purpose. And as I was preparing this morning, because I didn't just want to get something to just share because I'm a preacher. I wanted to share something that God has given to me for you. And I want you to prepare for your next level. I want you to prepare for your next level. This is the season that the Lord will dry the tears. This is the season the Lord will remove the pain. This is the season the Lord will remove the scars. And the Lord said, even those that reject you in one season, they're going to embrace you in this season. And there's going to be some reconnecting for realigning. And the Lord said, open your mind, because some people you think will never knock on the door again is going to knock on the door in this season, because they're going to recognize you in this season. And the Lord say, there are things he's going to beautify. The Bible says he made all things beautiful in his time. Some things could never look beautiful before his time. But this is the time and the season for God to make a lot of things beautiful. And this is what I hear. Beautiful in the thing that didn't make sense is going in one season is going to make sense in this season. And there's going to be a lot of opening. And I'm seeing opening, not just locally, but also globally. And I'm seeing God is going to give you an idea, and I'm seeing a brand, something with a brand. And I'm seeing it all over the internet. is going to be something that people is going to know about. There are days in this season of your life that God is going to wake you up between 1 and 3 and download stuff and show you stuff and show you you are in places, because the eyes of the seer is going to even open more. And even with the apostolic oil that God is about to release in its fullness for you to enter nations and opportunities, this, you are at a new level now. And many shall call you mama, mama. And I'm seeing large global outreach. We're going to be training an army of women in the African continent. And I'm seeing you training them to be entrepreneurs, self-esteem, class. Woman of God, your season is not just that. And I see the spirit. I even see your own pilot. God have big things for you. And God said, don't limit me. Don't limit me. It's like you entering to live a new life now. A new life now. And a lot of things is going to happen fast. God is going to accelerate it. God is going to put the people in place. You don't have to figure out how. But people is going to sponsor this thing. But global initiative. That's what I hear. Global initiative. Get ready for expansion. Get ready for elevation. And there are some specific things. And what I'm talking about, God is going to just make those things happen. You don't have to make them happen. The call is going to come. The opportunity is going to come because you have prepared yourself for a different season. And by the time 51, some of the things that I prophesied to you now, if I be a true prophet of God, you're going to start to see them coming into place, because God is going to do it quick. By the time 53, almost 3/4 of the things that I tell you is going to start, you're going to see it start operating, because God is going to accelerate it. And I want to pray for you now, because you don't need a sermon, you just need a word. Father, we thank you for your honor, we thank you for your grace, we thank you for your handmaiden, we thank you for bringing her this far, 50 years, and Father, we thank you for what you're doing. Lord, I thank you for what you have released in the anointing. Yes, that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither have entered the heart of men, the things that you have in store for them that love you. Father, and right now I pray your blessing upon your handmaiden. I speak grace. I speak favor. Lord, and every word you release, God, we come in agreement with it. And we call for everything to come into a divine alignment, just like you have already recorded in your book. Lord, the people in position, the people in place, the purpose, oh God, the timing. God, we thank you, God, Father, for your agenda being fulfilled in a life, oh God. We speak grace, oh God. We declare, oh God, good health, God. We speak strength. We speak, oh God, everything, oh God, Father, to fall into place. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we declare, oh God, song mind. We declare, God, dreams, vision, clarity. We declare, oh God, Father, in the name of Jesus, protection in the going out, in the coming in the name of Jesus, Lord, the resources, oh God, the institutions, oh God, Father, that you will impact, oh God, Father. We thank you right now, God, for making the way, Father, and we come in agreement with your will, and we declare that your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Lord, the prophetic, the apostolic grace that you have put upon us, we release it now. God, we speak divine favor. God, we declare every crooked way, God, you're going to go before her and make it straight. We thank you right now, God, for the grace, double portion of good health, resources, financial resources, human resources, Father, everything that is necessary, we speak it, we declare it, and so shall it be. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you, and may you walk in unstoppable favor and unlimited blessing. And I'm telling you, get ready, because these things is going to accelerate fast. If I be a prophet of God, it will not delay. It will not delay. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Bishop. Thank you so, so much. I receive every single word. I really thank you. And I just want to share how the prophetic works, because I know we have a mixed crowd on this platform. When I was doing my testimony, I stopped where I didn't intend to stop. And I didn't understand what God was doing, but I knew God was doing something. So I'm gonna just share with you all the end of my testimony that I paused at. And I really believe that the Lord allowed me to stop there so that you cannot say that Bishop knew when he said. So I ended up writing 5 books. A lot of you know about 1 or 2, but I ended up writing 5 books. I didn't realize that it was for the 5 decades of my life. So the first book that everybody knew about is Victory in the Valley. So I wrote that book and I made up my mind. I even had this conversation with Penny. I'm not doing any virtual book launch. I want my venues, I want my shenanigans. The books will stay right there until we could have a venue. Then I wrote another book, which Bishop knows about, The 7 Kingdom Principles for Corporate Women of God. Then I wrote a third book, The Scriptural Significance of Numbers. And it was 1 o'clock in the morning that I woke up and I heard Jubilee edition of A Woman's Worth. And I woke up at 1 o'clock in the morning and I wrote my 4th book, A Woman's Worth, Finding the Queen in You to Help Your King. And the next, I think it was a week after, I said, okay, I have 4 books. I heard, no, there's a number 5 missing. And I said, God, you speak and I will write. And I got up like about 2 a.m. that morning and I didn't go back to sleep. And I wrote my 5th book called There's a State of Emergency in the Kingdom. So these are my 5 books for 5 decades of my life. And when our loving prime minister and when things get back to normal, I'm gonna have an amazing launch, not just in Trinidad, but locally, regionally, and internationally. So the prophetic works. So thank you so, so much, Bishop, for all your words. And he knows I milk prophecy. He cannot speak a word that does not come to pass. I will milk it till it comes to pass. So let me get back into my zone because I am not the chairperson. Penny, over to you.
Thanks so much, Bishop James, Bishop Dr. Dexter James, for those wonderful words. I know that, Wendy, you have always been destined for great things, and you have done so many great things already. Looking forward to more, bigger, and better in Jesus' name. I want us now to move to the 3rd and final greeting corner. I'm not sure all who are on the call because I can't
call names and I will whistle.
So Prophetess
Leah Carrasquillo from Warrior. Yes, she is here.
Carrasquillo. Yes. Over to you, Leah.
Where's the prophetess? I am
your mic is muted, Leah.
Muted, yeah. Unmute.
I'm here, Minister Wendy. I'm here. I would like to say good night to you again and happy 50th birthday. I know we are the example of 50s because I am 50 also. So we are perfect example of being how a 50-year-old woman supposed to look like. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. So what I would like to say to you, this afternoon I was just lying down, just thinking about you, right? And the number 5 came into my spirit. I didn't know what it was going to say about 5, but the number 5 came into my spirit. And what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to you now, woman of God, that the next 5 years of your life will be the most crucial years, the most crucial years, 5 years. He said, as you consider ants, how they build their nests and how they communicate with each other. I am not calling you an ant, but I'm telling you, consider their ways. And God is saying to you now, woman of God, that he will give you a special skill set. A skill set, because this time in your life it will take a divine skills to build what he's going to download in your spirit. And when Bishop begin to speak two way of confirming his word and connecting his people. So I am just hearing the number 5555. Crucial years, crucial years. Skill sets, tools in your hands, spiritual tools to build what he's about to download in your spirit. And do not worry about the things that already passed. Do not worry about the things that people came into your life and they caused certain things to rumble. He said, that was my work in there. So as you continue to hold on to God and to sit at your prophet feet and to hold on to the word of God and work the work that he has given you for this season, everything will fall into place. So this is my encouragement to you at your age of being 50 years, be blessed as he continue to multiply you. I just see like he moving stakes, he moving your stakes from this place, which have been too long, he moving your stakes and he's just expanding you on every side. So as you go up, continue to be the woman of God that he have called you to be. Be blessed. This 50th birthday, be blessed. It's a new beginning. It's a new season. So be strong. And as you open your spirit, God will begin to download within you. So happy birthday again, ma'am. I wish you all the best. Not wish, but I pray all the blessings of God that he have in store for you in this IBS of Jesus.
Awesome. Thank you so, so much, Prophetess. Thank you. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay, so now I want us to move to Sister Annalene Cummings. Is she on the call?
Yes, she is.
From Empowerment Temple, representative from Empowerment Temple.
Where's Annalene? Unmute, my dear.
Okay.
She has to unmute. Okay, I'm not too sure why she's not unmuted. Go ahead to the next person, Penny, and we'll come back.
Okay, I want to move to the Associate Pastor Tricia Teasdale Durante from Evergreen in North Carolina. Are you on the call?
Hi, yes, I am. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Hi.
Pastor Tricia.
Yes, sweetie pie. All the love. Good evening to family, moms, hello, even to the bishop. Good evening. Thank you so much for inviting me. And I should say us, because my husband and the kids, they're just around. But Wendy, it's such an honor. And it's such a blessing. From Trinidad to London, back to Trinidad, and then I left in Trinidad.
Yes.
I came across to the States, you know. And it has been a pleasure knowing Wendy for over, I don't even know how many years. I can't
20, remember. 26.
Right. I wasn't even ordained yet. My husband and I weren't ordained. We just there as Christians going to church. And I remember while in London, when they did the song, no boy, no, you don't have to. My husband helped her, you know, write. He helped her write, pen, some of that, you know. And so at that time, it was really a trying time, but a beautiful time we had in London during those days. And so God has been working on your heart, and he was working, and he was calling, and he was working. And I remember there were times when Wendy may not have understood what God was doing in her life. And she would call, Trish, girl, I get this dream. Oh, I see something. And I said, Wendy, God is speaking. God is speaking. And God has been speaking. He is speaking, and he will continue to speak to you. You know, so it's truly an honor in this time, 2021, that you are in the land of the living. you continue to shine your light. All your friends and families have brought so many words of encouragement, and it has blessed my heart. Just being on the platform, listening to each and every one of you has been a blessing. You know, I'm sure if we didn't have COVID and we were in Trinidad, you wouldn't have 50-something people in your house. Probably not. Maybe not. But look what the Lord has done in the midst of the chaos, and has brought a caliber of people to support you on this day. You know, it's really, really an honor. So on behalf of even my husband, Pastor Jason, but your name is Jay.
Yes.
Jaysha, Jessa, Jadon, you know, and we're here in North Carolina now. Of course, you know, the doors are always open. You know, we've spoken that and we have a lot to talk about.
Yes.
But on behalf of the Durant family, to you, my love, my sister, happy, blessed, blessed birthday. So we're waiting for you. We're waiting for your
minute. I'll be there. I'll be there. Yes. All right. God bless. Amen. Love you guys. Thank you so much.
Love you.
Thank you, Pastor Tricia Teasdale Durante, and to the Durant family, as you said. I would like to move on to Uncle Mikey, or Bishop Henrik Lewis, also known as Uncle Mikey. Could you unmute your mic and bring your greetings? Is Uncle Mikey on the call? I saw him earlier.
Yeah.
Uncle Mikey gone?
Uncle Mikey gone?
It looks so.
Flo Penny.
All right. Okay, so.
Oh, no. Well, yes, but no. He's talking to Patrina, who's in transit. So he'll come back. Go ahead.
All right, so you let me know when to get back to him. So I want to move on to Wendy's aunt, one of Wendy's aunts, Mother Jennifer Mark, also known as Auntie Deborah. Auntie Deborah, are you there?
Yes, Mama, I'm here.
Pleasant, hey, good night.
Pleasant good night to each and everyone. Wendy, sweetheart.
Auntie Deborah, what happened to your camera?
I'm putting it on back, sweetheart.
Okay.
That's not it. It just come off. Yes, sweetie.
Yes.
God's riches resting upon your life, my sweetie. And I really enjoyed the word from your minister, a living stone. And being a child of God, I hope that you really remain a living stone. Because growing in ministry and growing from strength to strength, if God don't continue to pour oil in you and keep you like by his fountain, by the rivers where you could remain fresh and green, you can't do anything. So keep on embracing the Lord daily. Keep on growing from strength to strength. May he continue to anoint you, because your ministry ahead is a heavy load, but God has made all burdens light. So you know, because he thinks we know how to bruise our knees, so we will keep on doing that for you, that God will just strengthen you daily. So have a wonderful and a blessed 50th. And may it keep on shining as usually does. And may his grace continue to pour into your life. Have a blessed, 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 blessed one.
Thank you, my darling, Auntie D.
You're welcome.
Okay, thank you, Auntie Deborah. I want to move on to another aunt, Mother Teresa, aka Juliet. Auntie Juliet, are you on the call? You could unmute your mic, Auntie Juliet. Okay.
Pleasant good night to the bishop. A pleasant good night to the prophetess. All, you know, people of God, family in Christ, to the moderator, and a blessed, pleasant good night to my niece, Wendy.
Hi, Auntie Juliet.
It's a privilege, you know, to be alive, first of all, to witness and to enjoy your 50th year of your earth strong. I thank God for keeping you thus far.
Amen.
I give God the praise to see where you were and where you're at now. You know, Nicola, like I said, there's a time and a season under the sun for everything. This is your season. You know, I wanted us to talk on the number five, but your prophetess spoke on number five. Amen. I was telling your aunt and today when I was up there that I wanted to speak to you on the number five. But you already get the number five already. So then I can say that your bishop and your prophetess was on target with your going forward. in your spiritual life. I trust and I pray that as you go forward, that you will not let nothing bug you from reaching that goal, that level that God wants you to reach. I pray that you know you'll continue to be a light. That when men see you, they will say, yeah, that is a child of God. And that you can pour some of the light into some people, because in this room, plenty of people need a light, which is God. So that you can pour into their life and help them to become a good soldier for Christ. I trust as you go forth, that he will bless you in every aspect of your life, in your finances, most of all, in health, in helping, I want him to continue to help you to bring forth your speech. You love to talk, so I want him to help you bring forth more speech, utter more words. And you know, sometimes, I know you know how to put it over. You're a woman of dignity, of ethics. We have to say you're a woman of, you know, of collabora. You know, you know how to talk, you know how to walk, you know how to carry about yourself. And I trust that you install it into the young ones that are coming up. And while you're installing it, that they will be able to install onto others. I pray that you continue to leave your landmark wherever you go.
Amen.
I pray that you continue that wherever, whatever you touch, whatever you say, whatever will be a blessing unto people. I pray that God bless your hands. He bless your feet, that it will carry you into the right places. That he will bless, you know, your ministry most of all. So that when you stand with the authority of God. So that others there will bow down. I know that that is a child of God that is standing there, and we have to humble ourselves. You just continue doing God's work, and he will continue doing what he has to do in your life with faith. Because, like I said, there's a time and season for everybody under the sun, and this is your time. This is your season. You know, you've been through a lot, many changes in your life. But God have, if you haven't been through the changes, you could not have come now to give testimony. This is why God has put us as people through changes, through trials, so that we can stand now and give testimony. Because if you don't know the situation, you can't give nobody advice. So I thank God for the trials that you went through, so that you can stand now, that if someone going through that same thing, that you can understand, so that you can relate and put it over with God's word, so that they'll be able to overcome whatever they are going through. So I trust God, and I thank God for you. May you live to see many more. May you be prosperous. I bless God for my sister womb, that she have, you know, carried you for 9 months. I bless God for everyone that is on the chat here tonight, and may God continue to bless all you and strengthen all you, and may his love and his grace pour upon all your life. This is what I have to say tonight, in no other name but in Jesus Almighty name.
Amen. Thank you, Julia. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Auntie Juliet, for those wonderful blessings upon not only Wendy, but everybody else. Thank you for that. I want to move to yet more aunts. Is Jeanette Francis on the call?
No, go ahead. I've not seen her.
Claudette Roach?
Yes, she's here.
Mississippi?
Go ahead, Claudette.
Who is yours? Hi, good evening to everybody. I just want, my speech is going to be very short. I just want to take this opportunity to wish Wendy all the best. Thank God for 50. I hope that your journey from now on would be very happy. It might have its times, but I know that you can make it through. And I wish you all the best. I hope you live to see many, many, many more in God's wonderful name. Thank you, love you, and continue doing what you're doing, talking as usual. Bye. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, my dear.
Good. Like Wendy Boyd, they have you pegged with this talking thing. But that's, I just want to say, that. Not just talking, it's singing also, but never mind.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
All right, so I want to now move to some of Wendy's cousins. Is Vernie on the call?
I don't know, you know. Curtis Vernie on the call?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Yeah. I will move to Marlene and Larry.
Marlene definitely on the call.
Marlene, over to you.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we are.
All right. Hi, good night, everyone. Pleasant good night to everyone who's here listening internationally, regionally, and locally. So pleasant good night to Wendy, my eldest cousin on my mom's side. I'd like to say a pleasant good night and happy birthday greetings. Continue to you, darling. So I just want to pull up some things that I looked at today, and I find that it's so fitting in terms of everything that was said tonight and everything that you shared and everything that everyone shared about you. Now, I did a little research in terms of what's in a name, and I researched Wendy, and surprisingly, the original English meaning for Wendy was friend.
Wow.
And the biblical meaning for Wendy was the wanderer in the footsteps of the Lord. Hmm. And I said they were both so fitting, especially considering everything that was said. The fact that, you know, in terms of your journey and where you're going, and the fact that you've taken up the mantle to follow in the footsteps of the Lord. So I just want to say, Wendy, so firstly, you're my cousin by blood, but more importantly, you have been one of my greatest friends and my mentor. I have seen you strive in so many things that you have done, and even if there was a misstep, it never kept you down. You always dusted yourself off and you moved on to the next event, the next light pole, or the next challenge. You always move forward, and you've always inspired me by that. So just to be short and brief, just to say that as we celebrate you today, we celebrate your 50th birthday, 50th celebration of your life. I want to express how much I love you, and I want to say thank you. I pray that you remain grounded, because I hope that you remain grounded in your faith, and that you continue in your journey and your pathway to the grace of God. I hope that he continues to protect you, that he continues to bless you, and that you hold on and you see 50 more wonderful years. I love you. Happy birthday.
Thank you, my darling, cuz. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thanks, Marlene, for those lovely words. We've heard from Petrina, so now I want to go over to a category called besties.
Yes? Lisa Wickham needs to leave. Let her jump on before she leaves, please.
Sure, no problem. Over to you, Lisa.
She just, I hope I didn't see her message late. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead, Pen.
All right, so I want to go over to one of the besties, Carla Phillip, from joining us from New York. Carla, if you unmute your mic, over to you. Did Carla leave the call?
I don't think so. Skip, go ahead. She was just on the call, but go ahead.
All right, so you come back to Carla. Marsha Bailey Owens.
Skip.
Are you on the call? Marsha is not there. And Cavell Joseph St. Omer.
Most present and accounted for.
Cavell, over to you.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hi. I'm just trying to get the camera on. Just 1 minute. Right. Hi, Wendy.
Hi, darling.
You look so beautiful tonight.
Thank you so much.
So tonight, of course, we celebrate your 50th birthday, and we celebrate just the woman who you are. You know, you have been the light, the beacon, the power of, the tower of strength to all our lives, you know, and listening
to everything tonight. It gave me a greater sense of who you are as a woman. And I swear every time I either tune into a radio program or I tune into some event around you, I learn something new, you know, every single time I learn something new. But you're a beacon to many and to myself. You're always there for so many people when needed, and you continue to use your talents and your kindness to touch the lives of those around you, you know. On this occasion of your 50th, I just want to encourage you to continue to use all those God-given talents that you have through ministry, through the development of people, through your corporate academy, through your radio program where, you know, you have that listenership, a growing listenership, and you talk on so many issues, social issues that impact the lives of many women and men and young women and young boys. So just continue to use all those talents that you have, you know, because you were blessed with extra. You got the extra batch of talent when God was giving it away, you know. So the voice and the singing and everything else that you have, your personality, your ability to, as Randall said earlier, when you make up your mind on something, whether people on board or not, you're getting it done. You know, you're just a go-getter and you're an inspiration to many. And it's only fitting that we take this time to really honor you on your 50th birthday. Congratulations on reaching this milestone, joining the Half Century Club now. I just hope that in the next 50 years of your life will be just as amazing as this first 50. I do look forward to us being able to meet up again because we haven't seen each other in person for such a long time. So I do look forward to that. I do look forward to us celebrating in our own little way. And Wendy, I mean, just continue to be the person that you are, strong, dynamic, bold, inspirational, using all those talents. And thank you for, of course, including me and for being a part of my life. And I just look forward to continuing this journey along with you and us achieving things together. You know, I always have these big vision and big ideas, and I always tell you that. So I don't see anything small. I see big things for you, right, in your future. And I just would want to be there to witness it all. So God bless you always. Happy 50th.
Thank you.
Looking forward to seeing you in person, to being able to hug again, and, and to be able to celebrate.
Because I think the last time we met was last year for my birthday.
Yeah, we haven't seen each other in a very, very, very long time.
Yes. But we're in touch. Thank you so much. Love you, Lou.
So love you too. God bless. Good evening, everyone.
Thank you, Cavell, for those kind words. And we move on to Kasia Diaz-Kane.
Kasia.
Kasia Diaz-Kane. Over to you. You have to unmute your mic.
Hi everyone, good evening. I'm Keisha. Wow, I wasn't anticipating to speak tonight, but I was just so blessed by everything that everyone has been saying about my dear friend Wendy. I met Wendy, wow, almost 30 years ago.
Yep.
And I met Wendy through working at Kiskity Caravan, Amara Studios, and I met her through Curtis Grant.
Memories again.
And we just became really good friends. And when I moved to the United States when I was 22 years, Wendy, I met you when I was 19, 20 years old.
Yes.
And when I went to the States when I was 22, you know, I met Auntie Sheila, right?
Yeah.
Sheila. And, you know, we just became really good friends. And Wendy's always been someone that I can talk to about, you know, issues that's been on in my life. We communicate. I haven't seen her maybe in about 2-3 years. When I drove to New Jersey to see her, I think she was coming for some TD Jakes conference or something like that. Yeah. And, Wendy, you know, you're an amazing person. You've always been so kind. Your friendship means a lot to me. And I am so, so thankful for everything that, I'm not gonna get emotional.
I was about to say, we had this conversation.
Okay, let me calm down. I want to say thank you for just being an amazing person and a wonderful friend. And I am so blessed for where God is taking you and where he's going to just elevate you to new heights. Wow. And I'm to have you as a friend. Thank you so very much. And, you know, I've been through a lot, and to have people like you that I can look up to and I can call and just be able to be myself with. I thank you so very much. Thank you for holding my secrets. Thank you for being a support. And I just want to wish you a very, very happy 50th birthday. I'm right around the corner. I will celebrate with you because my birthday is in January. So I'm coming home for Christmas. I'm letting you know right now. Mom doesn't know. Please don't say nothing. And we will celebrate when I get home. I love you.
I love you too. Thank you.
Thank you, Keisha, Diaz, Cave. I have not seen any of the Alexanders on the call, so I'm going to
move on. Yes, I saw Shamaya.
Oh, Shamaya, are you on the call?
I saw Shamaya.
Representing the Alexanders?
Yeah, I don't know where Shamaya. Go on. Go ahead.
Okay, Flo. I will move on to Sherry John. Is Sherry John on the phone, on the call?
She was on earlier.
She was. I saw her earlier. Sherry, if you're on the call.
No, she's not. Go ahead.
Okay. I am on the call. Gosh.
Jesus, mercy, don't kill me. Oh, Lord. I humbly apologize to my cousin friend, Sherry. Sherry, what name you on? Were you under your name? Okay, my apologies.
I was on at maybe 7:05, 7:10. But I am not the talking ones with the friendship. Wendy is the talker. I am the one who sits back and she talks and I listen. When I have to say anything, I say what I have to say. But she is the mover. Everyone who knows Wendy knows she's decisive, and when she says she wants to do something, she's going to get it done. I am more the laid back one, heaving, hoving, indecisive. But Wendy, I just want to say in a decisive manner, happy birthday. Thank you for inviting me. This was a blessing. It's a fabulous Zoom birthday party. It's one of the unique ones. I must tip my hat off to you.
Thank you.
It was well organized. God bless you. May he continue to keep you. May he continue to guide your footsteps. And you know, I always tell you, I am very proud of you.
Amen.
Every time I see you, I tell you, Wendy, I'm very proud of you.
True.
And I continue to see that God has blessed you and he has kept you and you are moving forward. And I always like that about you. No matter what happens, you move forward. You do not get distracted and you keep moving forward. And with that mentality and being focused, God is going to use you in a tremendous way.
Wow.
And I can't wait to see it. I am going to sit back and enjoy all of your blessings as it comes. And I'm very happy and proud for you. I didn't mean to talk as long. You know, I'm not the talker with the friendship part, but hugs, kiss, moms, aunties, everyone's. I missed you guys. It's been a while. You know, as soon as I touch down from the airport, you get a text.
You know what I'm saying?
When I'm in New York, but the minute the plane lands, I call you and we pick up from there. Friendship is tight and strong. I don't always have to be touching base, you know.
True.
But I love you. Curtis.
I love you too.
Moms, all the aunties. All right.
Thanks, Sherry.
As always.
Thank you, darling.
Okay. Have a good one. Back off. Let me take off my mute.
Thank you, Cheryl. I see Carla Philip back on the call. I want to give Carla a chance on the floor. Over to you, Carla.
Thank you. So I'm back on the call. I must say my dear girlfriend wasn't joking when she said, stay on the call from the end, from the beginning to the end, when we spoke. But, yes. Oh, look at that. Okay, good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. You know, it's a pleasure to be on this call to celebrate my dearest girlfriend's milestone birthday. You know, just to give you a little history, Wendy and I have been friends, you know, in her opening testimony, she talked about having friends from secondary school and having friends for every season. Well, I am one of those friends that just fit into that bucket. I am one of those friends that fit into every season. And even the new season that we have, global warming, right? I'm always there. So, you know, Wendy, I have known Wendy for, wow, it has to be about, I know I've heard over 20 years, over 25 years, and I was counting today when I heard I was on the program. I said, okay, well, let me count. And then I said, you know what, let me stop counting, you know, because it's over 30 years. No, I'm not 50 yet, but it's over 30 years. And I could...
You're not far behind me, these months. No, I'm not
50. But I can say that up to 30 years, I can probably say there's just like 30,000 things that I can say about Wendy, but it's nothing new that you guys haven't heard this evening. You know, Wendy, you know, just having all of you on this call, you know, Wendy's always like well-connected, you know, like for people maybe from maybe childhood, and it'll go all, she's always in touch. That was always her. Very bold, very bright, very assertive. I mean, these are the qualities that she's had, like since we were going to, since we were going to secondary school in Trinidad. But, you know, I must say that our friendship has blossomed from, you know, our relationship has blossomed from a friendship to more of like family, right? You know, she's more of a sister to me. She is within my DNA, right? So, you know, it's like, so we're like blood for life. You know, and my love for her is just unconditional. And I'm just happy to be a part of this celebration with you this afternoon. Afternoon, my dearest Wendy. And you know, as I listened to you earlier today, I'm just so happy, you know, as you move on to a new chapter of your life and into being in the ordained ministry world, I know that you will do well. So I love you to pieces, and I know that we have many more birthdays to celebrate.
Thank you, Poopsie.
You're welcome.
That's her nickname, everybody.
Okay, I want to thank you so much, Carla. I'm happy that you came back on the call, because when I was calling you earlier, I was like,
absolutely.
I can't leave out Carla.
Of course not. You can't leave out Carla.
Good. I want to move now to the representative from the celebrants MBA crew. But I don't know who's talking. Is it Tiffany is going to talk for the MBA crew, or is it Latoya or Janelle? Who's going to talk? Tiffany? I saw Tiffany on the call.
They are all here. I think they were having a talk.
They all unmute their mics.
Evening, good evening.
Yeah.
Hi, good evening. Janelle.
Oh my God, my MBA crew.
Hello, Wendy.
Hi.
So, Wendy, I heard that you nominated moi. I don't know why Wendy likes to pick on me.
Toya, be here.
I'll put on my camera just for you, Wendy.
I just want to say, Toya, that actually, before you came on the call, Janelle nominated Tiffany, and Tiffany passed the baton.
Oh, I heard you nominated me.
You see? Let me clear my name.
I heard you nominated me. So
they hear that, you hear that behavior?
Yeah. So I got all fancy. I went to put on my white top and I turned on my camera just for Wendy. Awesome. Wendy, happy 50th birthday on behalf of the MBA crew. Well, you know, I am not the talker, right? So I'm not going to be long, but I'm just going to say, Wendy, you know, we started off our journey doing our MBA together at SAM. We have a lot of memories.
Yes.
Some that, you know, we won't share here, but we just wanted to say a few words to Wendy. I mean, in discussing, Wendy, we just did an acronym for you with your name. We just wanted to tell you you're wise, you're energetic, you are a no-nonsense person, and an inside joke, our group project, right? Dynamic. And why we would like you to encourage you with all the prophecy to give your hands to your human service, do what you have to do, Wendy. And, you know, we wish you many, 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 many more years to come. You know, having you in the group, you know, was awesome. We remember those nights and those days studying, going to Mr. Singh's office at UWE. Just to let you know, we still have that video, Wendy, of you under the table. We won't go into too much details, right? So we have that video of you. We will share it with you with the blanket. And you remember the red blanket, right?
Oh, my gosh.
I admire you. We admire you, Wendy, you know, in terms of you leaving South, you know, coming up to St. Augustine, heading back down South. Sometimes you're traveling. Sometimes even when we have the all-nighters, Wendy, you were there and, you know, you were behind us. You were pushing us. So, Wendy, thank you. Thank you for being part of our lives. Thank you for being there for us. And we'd like to wish you all the best.
Thank you so much, Latoya. Look, Janelle is making confusion in the chat. And Janelle is saying that I was the president of the Bankers Association.
Yes, yes, she was.
This is true.
Yeah, really good. This is true. NBA memories. Oh my God. Yes. Toya, you must send me the video.
Oh, we will share it. We shall share
we'll
it.
Share it
absolutely.
Here, you know?
No, what, I'm you want share it here? No, not here, not here, not here.
Love you guys.
Memories.
Love you too, Wendy.
Thank you guys for being here.
Okay, thank you, MBA crew. I know the people that you study and pull all-nighters with some of the closest people in your life as you move so forward, true. Because the stress of it all binds you together. So it's great to hear from your MBA crew. At this time on the program, I want to open the floor for some brief greetings from, you know, anybody else who would like to say something to Wendy on her 50th birthday but hasn't had the opportunity yet to speak. The floor is open. You can just open your mic and we'll see when you start speaking.
Hi, Wendy.
Hi.
Hi, Margaret Sampson.
Hey! Margaret Sampson, the one and only Margaret Sampson Brown.
How are you doing, girl?
I am honored. It is a privilege.
Hallelujah.
Oh, you know, let me just hear what you have to say.
I don't know Wendy as long as you all have. I only know Wendy just a few years ago, about 2 or 3 years, about 4 years.
Four years,
when we both shared a platform at a conference at the Hyatt Regency. And I saw this person walking in the conference. Now, Wendy set up a booth and this booth, and Wendy would not sit down. She's walking all over the conference, but she had a purposeful walk, and I kept looking at her because I'm attracted to persons who sometimes have the same purpose as I do. And eventually we did speak, and we spoke after that. But Wendy, what I want to tell you today is that you are so privileged to be in the presence first of God, and then to be in the presence of women and men of God. And, you know, I listened to your bishop and I listened to his word. And while he's speaking, while he was speaking, a word came to me that when God wanted to give Moses a mission, he hid him in the house of his enemies. All years. He hid him, and when the time was right, he extracted him from the house of the enemy and put him on solid ground to take his people from where they were to where he wants them to be. So I just want to share a line or two with you, my dear friend.
Don't be encumbered by the inability of others to prevent you from realizing your goal. Don't be encumbered by the inability of others to prevent you from realizing your goal. Continue with your ambition and don't apologize for it. Continue in your ambition and don't apologize for it. Let people see you in the full dimension of who you are. I'm listening to all the speakers and they say, I'm going to meet you there, but I have passed there. 1st of December, they say, I will be 70 years old.
What?
And I am enjoying every minute. The challenge was great, but you know what make it great? Is because other people believe that I would have failed. But you, Wendy, with all what we are saying, when we come off this chat, is between you and your God. Nobody else. You and your God. And I want to say to your mom, Mom, thank you for bringing Wendy into this world. Thank you for growing up, for growing her up the way you wanted her to be, because grow a child in the way it should be. And we know that Wendy will not depart away. So thank you, Mom, that today we could share Wendy. So Wendy, I am now your friend for life.
Yes.
And I won't step all away. God bless you, my dear.
Thank you, my dear. Love you loads.
Love you too.
I'm seeing Deborah Wilson. Deborah, take it away.
Wendy, Wendy, Wendy. Oh my gosh. Good evening to everyone on this beautiful call. I just want to say thank you for including me in this celebration of life that you're going through right now. And after what everybody has said previously, emotional. It's really an honor to know you.
Thank you.
Our paths crossed in MBA. You weren't in my class, but you know, we crossed paths again. We knew each other from South before, but you know, it's just everything. Continue to walk in your destiny, like I said earlier on. Live your purpose-driven life. And that's what you're doing. You're living a purpose-driven life. And may your cup continue to runneth over. And I'm glad that I am in the saucer to be amongst everybody here this evening. So happy birthday, my darling.
Thank you, my sweet.
Enjoy it.
Let me remind you, Deborah, it's long before the MBA. We were bridesmaids in my cousin's wedding.
Oh, yes.
I think we were like 12. We were bridesmaids in the same wedding. That's where it started.
And then so it's like you meet people in your life and, you know, as look at how we come back again. And I am just so honored to be here this evening with you and all your family and friends. And, you know, it's just, it's like I said, may your cup continue to runneth over. And I am glad to be in the saucer to experience all of this with you this evening. Thank you so much.
Thank you, my darling.
Happy
love you, Lord.
My darling.
Thank you. Alicia Ferguson. Unmute.
Hi, Wendy. Good night. Good night. Good evening to everyone. Wendy, you look so radiant. I love the hairstyle. I love the makeup.
You.
I just love you, girlfriend. I just want to wish you all the best on this wonderful 50th. Many people have not lived to see 50. And I pray God that He gives you 50 more because you have so much to unload. You are such a wonderful soul. I thank God for your mother, Cuts. I know her as Cuts.
Yes.
And I thank God for bringing you up in the fear of the Lord, because she's such a humble person and it resonates on you in your humility and all that you endure in the negative aspects of life. You always pull out on the positives. And for me, I'm going through a month of, you know, separation, and you also encourage me in terms of Alicia, without separation, there cannot be elevation. And I thank you for that. And, you know, I am just seeing that glow in you, Wendy. I know that God has so much in store for you. I came on just in time to see a bishop, you know, prophesy over your life and conversation just about a week and something ago. So I know that God is really, you know, working in your life. And I can't wait to see what he unfolds for you. You know, just keep on me say, God is so awesome. I could talk to you for the rest of the night, but I know, honey, other people want to share. But I just wanted to, you know, just God continue to bless your life and continue to order your steps and just continue to be obedient in everything that you do. I love you. I love you. I love you. And just enjoy. Just enjoy life, you
Thank
know.
Thank you so much.
I
want much.
To say cheers to you with my ISOT. I haven't seen people cheers,
I have
but
coconut
cheers
water.
To you, honey.
Cheers.
This is my ISOT to you and great things to come.
Thank
Blessings.
You, my darling.
I love you.
Love you loads. I am seeing Sister Allison Oy.
Yes.
Cheers, good. Sister Allison.
Pleasant good night, everyone. Pleasant wow. good night, Minister Wendy. Well, I am here sitting, my eyes filled up with tears, hearing everyone profess their love for you. And I must say that I am so thankful for, you know, getting to know you when you cordially strolled into my life probably a year or roughly less than a year ago, right? And I must say, you know, it has been a journey thus far. And I look forward to so many events with you, so many teachings and impartation. And you know, what stood out is how you just grasped me up. You didn't even ask, Allison, you know, I'm your mentor. You're my mentee. And I say, wow, Minister, I didn't even ask, but that's okay. That's okay. You know, and I'm so inspired by everyone and what they are sharing about you. And yeah, I look forward and you know, I love you tremendously. I am so thankful and grateful for all that you have done for me and all that you continue to do. And I will consider myself being lucky to be in Minister Wendy's life. So you continue to look fabulous, glow and grow. And just remember, we's one team.
Amen.
Love you.
Love you too. Thank you so much, Sister Alice. Now, I don't know who is Red Me. These nicknames. Who is Red Me?
It's me, Alexi.
Okay, hold on, Alexi. I want you to come in a little bit. Pastor Rachel.
Hi, Minister Wendy. Good evening to everyone.
Where's your camera, ma'am?
I don't know. Just now.
I need to make sure it's not an imposter.
Are you seeing me?
Yes. Hi, Pastor Rachel.
Hello. Good night, everyone. Good night, Minister Wendy. You know, I was listening to everyone talk about their interactions with you over the years. And, you know, we have not known each other for very long, but I told you before, and I will say it again, in the short time that I've known you, and I remember I started actually following you on Facebook. That's how I knew you. Some post I saw you on, and I started to follow you, and I felt like, you know, this person is a person with a good head on their shoulders, you know, always giving wisdom and real understanding to things, you know. And when you stepped into Warriors Assembly, you know, you're always a step out. So I was like, what, who is this lady? You know, you were one, I said, I think you came, you didn't have, you had the same hair. You didn't have any weave or anything. And I said, this woman.
So you had to tell everybody it was a weave, Pastor Richard?
No, but I was like, this woman brave, you know, because you were the second person that I had seen with a haircut like that. The first person was a supervisor I worked with in the bank, you know, and I know you had that same experience, that same banking experience. So that was something that I kind of connected with you on. But when you came into the church, you know, I was always amazed, always looking at you, and always there was just something that was different about you that my spirit connected with. I am not a person that connects with people often, you know. I don't have very many friends or people that I can call friends. So, you know, I was listening to all of your friends talk about their experiences with you and getting a little jealous in the corner here, but so happy that, you know, you have had that experience. And now I get to have that experience because, you know, we don't really talk often, but when we talk, it is something I never leave the same way, you know. I remember the last time we talked, it was really a trying time for me. And you just sit there, you listen, you just probably, I think you just asked one question. And it was, Pastor Rachel, how are you doing? And I was like, because people really take the time to stop to find out how you really doing. And you could really be having challenging times, you know? And so now that I've heard everything that, you know, a lot of people from different walks of life have shared about who you are, you know, it gave me a better understanding of, you know, who you are, you know, because we don't know each other like that. So I got to have that opportunity as being able to celebrate with you to find out things that I didn't know before, you know, and I'm really, really thankful and really blessed that you would have, you know, seen it fit to invite me. I'm very thankful. I'm very grateful. And I want to say to you, you know, it's your 50th birthday. You look amazing. And I know you will continue to look amazing. I know God will continue to elevate you. I know God will continue to bless you. And he has blessed you so far so much. You know, I will continue to look at you as somebody that, you know, I can model myself after. You know, and I really thank you for availing yourself and for being you, because, you know, coming from where I come from, there are or were very few persons that you could say, you know, that person is somebody that you could look up to. And for me, that person right now is you in my life. You know, there are certain people that stand out and you are one of them. So thank you and God bless you richly.
Thank you so much, my dear. And I know I'm going to Lady Adana next, but my sister-in-law Precious needs to dash. So I want to hear from Precious before she goes. So Precious, you can unmute, my darling.
Good evening, everyone. Gorgeous, how are you?
I am great. How are you, my darling?
I am good over here. Yes. You know, I'm back here and I'm hearing everybody and I'm like, Lord, what is one thing that impacted me? And Wendy, your assertiveness, the way that you dealt with situations is one thing that impacted me, because even though people may have wronged you, you dealt with it in a dignified manner. And you know what? I remember the day when we were at Bootleggers having lunch. And the service was so horrible. But the way that you dealt with it, we left with our bellies full and our pockets full as well. But you know, let's just see, she's asserting her rights and it's like, she doesn't even speak down to you. She just lets you know as it is. You know, and that impacted me as a young woman to know, okay, I can stand up and deal with things in a dignified manner. So I want to let you know, sometimes you may think people passed your life and how it impacted you, how you impacted them, sorry, and I want to let you know that you left a mark in my life as a young woman. You know, I am so glad that I'm able to reconnect once again, you know, and even as your apostle was speaking, I was like, you know, I don't know why God reconnected us in this season, but it had to be for something good. Amen. So I believe that even now in this season, we are being reconnected for purpose. And I am so happy you are walking in purpose and that God is just taking you from one place to the next. You know, you have always been a woman of vision. So everything that Apostle also prophesied over your life, I can actually see it happening because you are a woman of vision. And I want to let you know that I love you dearly. Love you, love you, love you.
Love you, love you, love you. Come back to
our part.
All right? I know, so right? Happy
50th. Yes, yes, yes. You know, sister-in-law, you know.
Sister-in-law for life.
So love you so much. Continue to enjoy your 50th. You look gorgeous. Nothing close to 50.
Thank you.
So I hope when I reach up there, I can look as good as you. Yeah.
You will.
So, mwah. I love you.
Honey. Love you. Love you, darling. Lady Adana, aka Marsha Clifton, Lady Adana. Unmute, my love.
Good evening, everyone.
Hey.
Happy birthday, Wendy. Thank I want to share, I don't know if I ever told you this, but I'm going to take this opportunity to do that. And my apologies for being late. I am doing Yoruba, and I had a class today.
Okay.
But I want to remember walking on stage on the opening night and looking in the audience to see if I would see you. And once you were there, there was a sense of comfort that will come over me because I know that from the moment I began to sing, as long as that song was to standard, there would be a slight smile that would come over your lips and you will rock back and fold your arms and there'll be a nod that I feel only I in the whole place would see. And when that nod comes to myself up on stage and I'm singing and I'm saying, yes, this one is good. The moment that I didn't get that, I tell myself, Marsha Gill, you have some work to do because that song not doing the job it was supposed to do. I remember one night you said to me, you know when I see you walk on stage, you know I look forward to that because you're theater. Well, you don't know how you made mine.
Wow.
By simply telling me those words, you inspire me. I remember when I reached the 50 milestone and I felt good about me. And honey, you're rocking that 50 like a boss.
Thank you, I pray, mother.
That God will continue to bless you and inspire you to continue to inspire others.
Yeah,
because everybody has a purpose. Everybody has a walk, you know, and sometimes our purpose and walks intertwine. And I am thankful that I was given the opportunity to share this space with you, this virtual space and this marketplace called Earth, and to bring it back down.
Awesome.
Marsha, you're breaking up a little bit. Wendy, I think we lost her.
Okay, because she was breaking up a little bit.
You know, I want to thank God for you. Continue to run it. I don't know.
Awesome.
Richest blessings to you. And all
thank
my
you, life. My darling. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Evangelist Jen and then Alexi. Evangelist Jen.
Hi, Minister Wendy. You hearing me?
I am hearing you, but I'm not seeing you.
Okay. I don't know why my camera giving trouble. I try all.
I will all excuse kind of you. Thing. Your picture looks nice.
Thank you. A pleasant good evening to everyone. I want to say happy birthday to you, woman of God.
Thank you.
For the short time I know you, you have impacted my life so much. I mightn't speak that much, but you have done something to me. I could remember seeing you for the first time in the Uncommon Church, and it's like you stand out. And I was like, wow, I would like to meet this woman someday. And then eventually when you came to Warriors Assembly, I was like, thank you, God, your answer my prayer. Because you're a woman of such excellence. And for me, I look up to you. You are my role model. Because, you know, you walk a walk that maybe any young girl might want to follow. And I just want to tell you, thank you for taking up the call that God has placed on your life. I want to say thank you for being you. And thank you for, you know, allowing us in your space and taking us under your wings. And I just want you to continue doing what the Lord has in your life and continue to look fabulous, continue to stand out like you usually do. And I heard somebody said, when you step into a room, is a presence, and I just love your aura. And I want you to know that, woman of God, I love you and I do appreciate you. And I just want to thank you for everything that you have done so far in my life. And I will really, as Sister Allison say, you know, walk that walk, because where we are heading, you know, you have already passed through that. And I remember Bishop said something, you know, to reach or to go where you have to go, you must be in the presence of people who have passed there already. And you're a woman of greatness. And I just want to be connected to you because I know that I will reach far. And I do not despise the grace on your life. And I love you. And I just want to say, God bless you, woman of God.
Thank you so much, Evangelist Jen. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I have a special. Where's Alexi?
Yeah. Hello.
Late but great. Nice to see you. My late cousin Alexi. Take it away, my darling.
Well, first and foremost, say good night, everybody, and happy birthday. May God continue to bless you with everything your heart desire. And may you walk with knowledge, wisdom, and understanding on an everyday basis, as usual. So everybody, this is like little brother to Wendy, right? So it's a little interlude because I know everybody is a lot more spirit-filled at this point in time. So you should know this song is an interlude. So I hope that you really feel and everybody who's listening, if you want to sing along, put on a mic and sing along also. All right?
Before you start, Alexi, if you're singing along, sing in key. Go ahead, Alexi. I just need you to put that part in.
Oh gosh. All right.
I love the Lord and I lift my voice to worship you. Oh, my soul, rejoice. Take joy, my King. In what you care, there is a sweet, sweet sound in your air. I love the Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul, rejoice. Take joy, my King, in what you care. Let there be a sweet, sweet sound in your head. I love the Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul, rejoice. Take joy, my King, in what you care. Let there be a sweet sound. Let there be a sweet,
sweet sound. Let there be a sweet, sweet sound in your head. Happy birthday.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. See, although you're late, was worth it.
I watch your auntie crawling here.
What's she crawling for? She talk already.
Because I'm late.
Oh, yes, yes. Understood. Understood. Ken, over to you. I'm seeing there are folks on the call. I'm not seeing any more hands. If there's anybody else who would like to speak.
Just unmute your mic and go ahead.
Pleasant evening, my dear Wendy.
Hey, Allison.
And you said folks, so I take that literally.
Actually, her surname is folks. Awesome.
Okay, I will be very short. Listening to all the speakers before, I just have to echo what they said because I don't want to be repetitive, but I'll only add, oh, God bless, no man keeps.
Amen.
Right? Well, Wendy, I think we have known each other for about roughly about 3 years.
Yes.
And even within that time, you know, we used to speak many times on a daily basis. Yes. Not just a daily basis, but many times on that daily basis.
Yes.
And when we would meet in our common spaces,
yes,
you would know there were serious issues that to keep our sanity, we would have to make a nice joke out of it. And I know you would know what I mean, right?
Yes.
A nice joke out of it. So I really, really miss those times. Due to what we are in right now, you know, it is not possible to share those moments, but it will live on, right? But I just want to say continue to be blessed.
Thank you so, so much.
And everybody would say, they hoping to meet you there, but I would join with Miss Samson Brown. I'm not where she is, but I've already gone past you. And do me a favor, when you next look at my WhatsApp profile, from 60 and fabulous to you 50 and fabulous.
Wonderful. Thank you, my darling.
Okay.
I see a hand up from Akola Ashby. Go ahead, Akola, unmute your mic.
Hi, good night, everyone. Y'all can hear me, right?
Yes. Akola, hi.
Well, hi again, Minister Wendy. I just want to say again, happy fabulous 50. And I
thank
must say, like, July Women Rocks, as I celebrated my 24th last week.
Yes.
And though I may not have known you as long as many speakers tonight, but listening to their kind words and hearing your testimony made me understand why I connected to you so much from the first instance when I met you on your program, A Woman's Words. And I just wanted to let you know that your love and inspiration and that whole positive aura about you, it is contagious. And as I told you recently, you motivate and inspire me. And it's an honor and pleasure meeting you and being a part of your fabulous 50 birthday celebration. So may God continue to richly bless you and continue to walk in your divine purpose. And I love you. Happy birthday from Tobago.
Thank you so much. I love you too. Thank you.
Kathy Ann, I'm seeing a hand up from somebody called Kathy Ann. You can unmute your mic, Kathy Ann.
Hi, good night to all. I would like to echo all that have been said thus far. And what we have to realize sometimes is that we all have a purpose, even though it might not have revealed itself before. But the journey that you would have had would have been leading you to that ultimate purpose that was in store for you. So everything, Wendy, that you would have encountered, that you would have done thus far, has led you to where you are right now, at this very moment, you know, bringing forth that purpose that was there for you. And what you would have ultimately done is touch the lives of many who you would have met, you would have inspired, you would have encouraged, and you know, you would have brought out so much in them that otherwise would not have achieved. And I'm speaking for myself too, because I have learned quite a lot. Yeah? Both sometime, yes, but I learn, right? And I am saying you're awesome. Happy birthday. Enjoy.
Thank you.
And the life just begun at 50.
Amen. There's
so much more that you have to reveal. And as somebody mentioned before, God bless.
No man curse.
No man curse.
Thank you so much.
Your birth month.
Yes. Yes.
Our month is yours.
That's right. Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, darling.
And just on a side note, I think she left already, but Marty, who was on, and I played together, I don't think she realized.
This space is too small. I will remember to share that with her.
All right.
Thank you so much. But
I want to recognize there are two more people, Wendy, that need to speak. They have their hands up and they've been waiting.
Okay, I just want to slip in that I know everybody keeps saying to me how fabulous I look. That's Kathy. Kathy is my designer, all my clothes, everything in ministry, that's Kathy. So thank you, I'm seeing. So take it away, Pen.
I want to go back to Claire Guy, Alan. Hey, how are you? Take it away.
Well, my goodness, I came on late. Sorry about that, Wendy, because you know
how. That's okay, I know your duty calls, yes.
Yes, but I'm telling you, since I've been on the live, my drawers, my cheeks are hurting because I have been smiling at all the lovely things people have been saying about you. And, you know, it makes me now understand. I think we never met in person. We are virtual friends.
That's right.
We are virtual friends.
This is interesting and true. We've never met in person.
Never met in person.
Wow.
And I love you so much.
I love you more.
Yes, and I want to say 50 is the new 20. I want to say a special good night to everyone and to Miss Samson Grong. I know Miss Samson Grong have a lot of integrity, but yes. I just want to put it out there. I do not believe her when she says she's 70.
Listen to me.
I'm not going to believe that until I see an ID card.
Something.
Three. I want three modes of
ID, DP, passport, everything.
Yes. Mm-hmm. But if that is the case, 50 is the new 20, 70 is the new 25. You ladies look gorgeous. And I want, when I reach that age, I look just as gorgeous as you ladies. You
will.
Yeah?
Stick with us.
All the best to you. All the best. Continue what you're doing. Your God purpose, God-driven spirit. You're really a wonderful person. And you bless everyone that you interact with. And
thank
I pray
so
that
God
gives you life and strength throughout. Good night.
I receive. Thank you, darling.
Yes.
Thank you, Claire. I didn't know you know my wonderful friend, Wendy. All the time
Small world.
Small world, indeed.
It's true.
Yes, indeed. I see Abby Bruno has her hand up.
Abigail Bruno, that's my girl. Hey, Abby.
Hi, darling. Good night.
Hi.
Wow. 50 and fabulous. 50 and fabulous on the outside, 50 and fabulous in the inside. I think my love for Wendy grew when my mother passed. And I looked out and I saw Wendy in the street that night. And you kept on calling and you kept on asking me how I was doing. And my heart just opened and I think we just grasped and you became close to my heart. And today is a special day because now you leave one era and you enter the other. Welcome to our club. Today I was not feeling too well, but I knew I had to be here, and that is determination, because I needed to be here for you tonight. Wendy, I love you. Wendy, I wish all the best for you and blessings. blessings and blessings. Happy birthday, darling.
Thank you, darling. I love you.
I'm going and sleep now and I'm feeling too well. Bye-bye.
We'll talk.
Yeah.
I'll call you tomorrow. Yeah. Thank you, darling.
You're welcome.
And I see Marsha Ray has her hand up.
Marsha Ray LeBand. Wow. Unmute, sweetheart.
Unmute, yes. Good night, Miss Wendy. I mean, I know you wouldn't forgive me if I didn't say something.
Correct is right.
But I want to say that you always do extra. I mean, what is this? Everybody just have a little birthday party that is last a little 2 hours and think, but no. You know, and it is really true. You walk into a room and you command the presence. So I want to wish you all the best, all God's blessings. As you said, you milk your prophecy, and I know you will, and you will walk into all that God has for you. I too want to be there to witness it. I really want to, because I wish you great things, and I know you are capable of doing it, and I am glad to be considered among your friends that I am there to witness this with you. So all the best to you, Wendy, and God continue blessings, and you do look fabulous. Welcome to the 50s club.
Thank you, my darling. You said you wanted company, so I'll join. Thank you so much. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, thanks, Marsha. If there is no one else who would like to say anything, I just want to thank you all for coming, and I want to hand back over to Wendy, who will give us the final vote of thanks as we close off the proceedings. Over to you, birthday lady.
Thank you so much, Pen. Thank you so much. I'm seeing somebody's raising their hand. There's a Trini.
Somebody called Cooper.
Yeah, you are the only Cooper in the dance. I have Rel.
Yeah. All right, Cooper. Yes. Take it away.
Yes, my cousin. Yes, oh, my God.
Hey. Good night. Hey, how are you doing?
I'm good.
Good night to everyone. Auntie Kathleen, everybody on the chat. Greetings from the Cooper family and everybody. Special greetings to Wendy. I thank God for you in a special way, and I hope that, you know, God would continue to bless you and, you know, fulfill everything that he has in store for your life. You know, I know that you are inspiration to a lot of people, and I pray that your light is going to shine, you know, that men may see, you know, God, what God is doing in you. And what is he going to continue to do in you? And, you know, I thank you for even inviting me on this chat to celebrate with you. The only thing is, with this virtual chat now, not like we could come and get a little sweet bread or a little sugar cake, like what Tante Mama used to do a long time.
You understand?
You know, so that's the only thing with this virtual chat and whatnot. But, you know, I thank God for the celebration that I could have the opportunity to celebrate with your 50th birthday. And God blessing. And, you know, I had to sing a little thing for you.
Take it away.
So, great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercy you see, and all that you needed, thy hand has provided. For great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto you. For great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. And morning by morning, new mercies you see. And all that you've needed, thy hands has provided. For great is thy faithfulness, for great is thy faithfulness. For great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto you. Happy birthday.
Thank you so much. Love you, Cass.
I love you too.
Okay, thanks for that, Cousin Cooper. Back to you, Wendy, for your vote of thanks.
I want to thank God for allowing me and to see this milestone. I want to thank God for choosing me. I want to thank God for my mom. I want to thank God for my dad, my brothers, my family, my friends, everybody who have, you know, been an integral part of my journey. There's nobody that I invited that didn't play an important role in my journey at some point. So it doesn't really matter. We're not looking for longitude. We're looking for latitude. We're looking for purpose, and purpose doesn't really have a timeline. So although you may not have known me for like 25, 30, 35, 45 years, like some, you made an impact in my life, which is why you're here. So I wanna say thank you to each and every one of you all, Apostle Diane Wilson, my Bishop, Dr. Dexter James, Prophetess Leah, Prophetess Josanne from Tobago, Prophetess Jillian, all the members of the File Phone Ministry, Evangelist Jen, all the men and women of God, my Uncle Mikey, my aunts. Penny, thank you so much. You did an amazing, amazing, amazing job. I know that I'm spirit-led, and I was like, who is gonna chair this thing? I said, you know what? Penny knows everybody. She knows the London side, the Trini side. Every step of the way, Penny knows everybody. So she'd be able to fit in and relate and do an amazing job. To my brother, Kurt, he just shocked the living daylight out of me. So these flowers here, you guys know we're in a state of emergency, right? You all know we have curfew. You know flowers ain't no essential. So I was by my mom and somebody called and said, there's a delivery for you at front. And when I walked up to the front, a car pulled up and gave me this big bouquet of flowers. I'm like, who is this? And when I looked at the card, it was a whole orchestration. Curtis ended up finding Jackie Kuhnhau, who said, you know what, that's Miguel, I will put it together. So for all the love, for all the presents, guys, I got some amazing presents. And the fact that you guys are here was my greatest gift of all. So I want to say thank you so much. Have an amazing night. And as soon as things get lifted, well, those who are in Trinidad, you know, we have to do something. So God bless you all. I love you and stay safe.
Love you too, dear.
Thank you very much, Wendy. Everybody have a good night.
Bye, everyone.
Same to you. Have a good night.
Happy birthday. Love you.
Love you. Thank you.
Happy
birthday. Beautiful. Thank you. Thank you.
Bye-bye, Wendy.
Hey, Prophetess Leah. Cherry, you're looking like you're falling asleep.
Lord, I'm tired.
Thank you for the sacrifice, everyone, especially my London crew, my Toronto crew, the foreigners. Thank you so much. I know it's a sacrifice to be up at this time. Thank you so much. Claudette, okay. Wake up.
Okay,
Leon Filbert. I know you're the shy one. You don't like to talk, but
Leon is so much. Leon.
Yes.
Wendy.
Yes, I love you guys. I see like y'all don't want to go, so I'm just going to chill until you guys decide.
Okay, no, I am leaving. Good night.
Good night.
Bye.
Bye. Good night, everyone. Love you all.
Bye-bye.
Have a good one.
All right, after party.